Big Brother, mainstream media, government cover-ups. You want answers? Well, so does he. He's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. And now, live from Austin, Texas, Alex Jones.
We're live, my friends. It is Thursday, the 22nd day of September 2011. I'm Alex Jones, your host. We're going to be live here for the next 3 hours today. Kurt Haskell, survivor of the Christmas Day underwear bomber attack a year and a half ago, or now more than a year and a half ago, will be joining us with some big breaking news in the third hour today. He and his wife, both attorneys at law, survived the firecracker slash firebomb that did set part of the plane on fire and were eyewitnesses to what really happened. He's now been going to the trial of Mutallab and has some incredible information. The standby lawyers, because Mutallab has fired his lawyers, are saying that they do believe it's an inside job staged event and entrapment is going to be their defense. But Mutallab, under torture or under threats to his family, we're not sure. This is standard procedure. Just like McVeigh's family was threatened, we know, has said that he's going to go ahead and say that he did it and go along with it. So amazing information. And, of course, it's a fact the U.S. government did get him on the plane and got him his visa. That has been admitted to in Congress. In fact, Haskell was on the TV show the other night, the Nightly News, and he brought up the C-SPAN clip. We should probably get Undersecretary of State, David Kennedy. You just type into YouTube, Undersecretary of State talks about underwear bomber being helped by U.S. government. That should pull up that YouTube. For listeners, that's particularly powerful for folks that go, oh, yeah, right, the government got him on the plane. But it's always the same in these high-profile events. They're always staged. If there's a terror attack that's real, you'll really never see it in the media or it's a minor footnote. And there are some people that go haywire and engage in asymmetrical attacks on the government and different governments throughout history. But again, when it's not hyped up, then it's a real event. They don't give it attention. When it's staged, which it is about 98% of the time, you will see absolute instant talking points because they're targeting the lowest common denominator. The system is targeting people they know really aren't paying attention to what's really going on and happening. Now, here's the deal. We're going to go to break here. A little bit of unorthodox radio I've been doing here in this particular time slot, 11 to 2 Central, since, I don't know, 1998. So what is that, 13, 14 years in this particular time slot, where instead of just having news in the first 5 minutes, we always cover news and information here ourselves and then come back from break and kind of restart the show. And so we'll do that when we come back. We had an incredible InfoWars Nightly News last night with Dr. Wakefield in studio. I did about a 15-minute analysis of eugenics and past chemical biological testing on the American people, including the murder recently of foster children in pesticide test. We show all of that and then illustrate what's really going on with the vaccines and then had Dr. Wakefield in studio. I've just told the Nightly News crew that we always send out the Tuesday night show to everyone who is a InfoWars Insider subscriber. We always do that with the Tuesday night show on Wednesday. But this one is so important. At the end of the show today, I'm going to send last night's hour-long special report on eugenics and vaccines and more because it's so important out to everybody who's an InfoWars Insider subscriber. It's free. Go to InfoWars.com. Up at the top corner, you'll see InfoWars Insider. Just put your email in there, hit subscribe, and you will be sent last night's special report to your inbox. That way you can forward it to everyone you know. And of course, if you want all the shows, the restreams, the high-quality archives, all the films, my book, Paul Watson's book, the special reports, 8.5 years of media and information in one spot. It's prisonplanet.tv. Now, more reasons than ever to be a prisonplanet.tv member, and you support alternative media. We'll be right back. Stay with us.
A very wealthy U.S. citizen is predicting that in 2011, we will witness the most important day in America in more than 50 years. He says it will change everything about our lives. The way you shop, travel, invest, educate your children, and even how you take care of your health and your own family. Now, this man has made some outrageous predictions over the years. The crazy part is, he's usually right. You see, he predicted the collapse of GM, Fannie Mae, Freddie Mac, and America's biggest mall owner, General Growth Properties. In fact, Barron's called his work a dire prophecy. Recently, he created a video, which you can watch online for free, detailing his biggest and most important prediction yet, and it's a real eye-opener. I can't stress this enough. You should at least watch this free video online today. He explains everything you need to know, including simple steps you can take to protect yourself. You can find the video at www.endofamerica3.com. That's endofamerica3.com. Watch the free video at www.endofamerica3.com. That's endofamerica3.com.
This is Alex Jones with five good reasons you should consider buying a solar power generator. Number one, new climate legislation could easily double or triple your electric bill. Number two, our new energy czar wants to control how much power your electric company allows you to have. It's true. Total government control of electricity in the name of smart grid technology is coming. Number three, in some areas of the country, the power grid is dangerously overloaded. And now, new socialist legislation is only compounding the problem. Number four, dangerous weather is always a threat to local grids. Every year, thousands of families lose their power from weather-related outages. Number five, a solar power generator provides powerful backup insurance and peace of mind. Folks, I really believe in the solar power generators offered by Solutions from Science, one of my oldest sponsors. You can get more information at www.mysolarbackup.com. That's mysolarbackup.com. Remember, the government doesn't own the sun, so go to mysolarbackup.com or call 1-877-327-0365.
Hello friends, Alex Jones here. You all know I've worked for years with Steve Shank and eFoods Direct. I have eFoods for my own emergency food supply. You know, Steve, life is different now for all of us, isn't it?
Very different. People are using this great food to survive the present hurricane season, and we've already had $40 billion worth of damage from floods, storms, quakes, and droughts. And that's just the first 8 months of this year. Natural disasters are newsworthy, but only touch a few of us Americans. The huge issue of the greatest depression is on everyone's mind. The unemployment, the loss of homes, lost businesses, and skyrocketing food costs are hitting every American. So everyone needs food security.
Folks, this month you will get free shipping on every food order from eFoods Direct. That's right. Every order gets free shipping starting September 6th. Get stocked up with the best storable foods out there with eFoods Direct and be prepared for any emergency before it happens. To take advantage of this special, call 800-409-5633 or go to eFoodsDirect.com/Alex.
Genesis Communications Radio Network proudly presents The Alex Jones Show, because there's a war on for your mind.
We are live. It is the 22nd day of September 2011 on this Thursday edition. The Dow Jones Industrial Average has dropped more than 300 points. Soon it's going to be more like 400 if it continues to drop. Of course, the stock market is admittedly completely rigged and run by the private Federal Reserve, along with the federal government that dumps, in some cases, billions of dollars a day into it to select stocks. And the whole thing is an insider trading scam. They occasionally burn some mid-level minion like Bernie Madoff to create the illusion that it's all above board. It is a giant casino designed to get your retirement, designed to basically get you into a Ponzi scheme and then hold you hostage to the globalist. Of course, Kurt Nemo on Monday at Infowars.com wrote that the federal government was preparing QE3. How did he know that? Well, because Bernanke promised 2 months ago that they would not have QE3. Now, when they do that, you know that they're lying. Even when the truth serves them, they lie, because they're insider traders. They don't want you to be ready. They don't want you to know. They want you to go make another investment so they can burn you, just like the Goldman Sachs email show, where they're calling their customers scum, saying we're selling them total crud. They used a profane word. Just amazing information. And so it's all about setting you up. It's all about gutting you. It's all about bankrupting you. It's all about controlling you. It's pure and total avarice. Now, Kurt, though, of course, in his article, wrote that the IMF and World Bank, which are just Federal Reserve branches worldwide, the same private cartel of less than six major banks and just a few families, that they were saying, yes, we want you to have QE3, which, again, will further devalue the dollar, that will give the major central banks and their shareholders more unlimited credit at below 0% interest, so they can loan it out to you at 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, or even 70-plus percent annual interest rate. And so we've got all that going on, and they're claiming that they're doing this twist program that hasn't been used in more than 50 years to move towards issuing more long-term bonds, quote, as a way to get the banks to loan. Ladies and gentlemen, the big banks run the federal government. They run Osama bin Bernanke. They are following their program of musical chairs, and they all get a seat, and you don't, I don't. That's how this works. They know when they raise taxes, it makes our jobs move offshore. They know when they put new regulations in that China and India and Mexico and 100-plus other countries are exempt from, it destroys our jobs. This is a stated post-industrial world. It's globalism. It's designed to deindustrialize us. They know exactly what they are doing. They are cold-blooded corporatists that control the government and who have investments in the third world and are shutting us down and in the process making us more dependent on them. This is all premeditated. And until that understanding is clear in everybody's mind, there is no hope of reversing it. We told you that Ireland, of course, they said, was the per capita fastest growing, least in debt country in Europe. The minute they signed on to the Lisbon Treaty, the minute they entered the euro, their entire economy was folded up like a tent, and they were told, you're now going under foreign bank ownership, even though it's not your debt. Their own head of their central bank said it is an honor to take on the debt of the IMF and World Bank and the mega banks, and it's good that Ireland is now run by foreign banks. He actually said that. You can look it up in the BBC, all over the place. Head of Irish Central Bank says it's good to have. We ought to pull that back up. We haven't showed that in months. Head of Irish Central Bank says it's good for Ireland to be run by foreign banks. That is a quote. It was all over the Irish and British newspapers, all over the UK newspapers. The minute they signed on to the euro, all that was a corporate agreement to take on the debts and obligations of the private banks that run Europe. Now they keep having bailout after bailout, claiming it's about Greece. They're bailing out the, quote, derivatives. They're signing on to the Ponzi scheme, okay? And now they've announced, oh, Bank of the World based in Europe, Germany's got to raise all its taxes, cut all their pensions. By the way, Germany's worked hard. They're in good financial stead to fund the establishment of a private financial union, which has been called by many European newspapers a private financial dictatorship. That is exactly what it is. And I listen to Bloomberg and watch CNBC, and they say the only obstacle to our global governance is the Germans and the fact that they can vote. Merkel, in the last two elections, has almost lost control. She's got a few seats left in the parliament, and then she will be removed. And then they have bankers on to go, it doesn't matter. It's the only course. We'll get it one way or the other. We'll just bring it up forward again and again. Germany doesn't have a choice. Their entire financial system will implode unless they bail this out. And that's the trap. And you bail it out again and give up more sovereignty, more liberty. And it gets worse. Same thing here. You notice, ladies and gentlemen, the minute he announced the QE3, the plunging began. And they love that. They'll drive the market down more, and then the globalists will come in, knowing when it's the bottom, and buy up again and do it over and over and over and over and over. And I got emails and got calls a couple months ago, and I said, you watch, there'll be QE3. And they said, Alex, he's not going to say there's not going to be QE3 and then double back. And Bob Chapman said, no, you're right, Jones. They're just not going to call it QE3. That's exactly what they're doing now. Again, it's all about deceiving you. It's all about saying, oh, please walk right through, welcome to dinner, and sticking your leg out to trip you. It's so funny to them. It's so much fun. And their disdain for you, their hatred for you. I was thinking about, in fact, I want to open the phones up on all these issues. I was thinking about this little tidbit, and finally it broke all over the media yesterday, saying the Orwellian policies of OnStar. Let me just not even sit there and make a claim of a quote. Let me actually just pull it up for you here. I've got a whole stack of these from last night that we covered on the nightly news. Here it is. OnStar begins spying on customers' GPS location for profit. Here's another one. New OnStar privacy policy expands on data sharing. That's a nice way to describe spying from CNET. Here's another one. OnStar's new Orwellian terms and conditions. Here's the register. GM OnStar cars will upload all data unless users opt out. Actually, I've read the agreement. It says they'll still do it. You have to physically remove the cell phone tracker box. It's coming. Your car will rat on you to insurers. Okay, there it all is, okay? Now, here's the actual OnStar policy. We have it linked in the articles at Infowars.com and PrisonPlanet.com. Now, I told you 12 years ago, I was contacted by an engineer that worked on this. And they said, listen, the government dials in, it's a cell phone, they're listening, they're tracking, the data's being sold. I warned people. Years later, it came out the FBI is listening without wiretaps. Ladies and gentlemen, everything, your iPhone, your Droid, when Google hijacks your computer, they put out a press release 5 years ago and admitted it. School laptops are issued. Everything has AI computers recording everything and saving the keywords. It's all completely illegal. Why now are they coming out? Well, now they're just sending you, because now they want to start going public with its use. Now they're simply sending you, in the terms and conditions, the announcement that even if you turn off the service, they're going to listen to you and sell it, it says, to law enforcement, insurance companies, everybody. In fact, let me just give people a document cam shot. They're watching on PrisonPlanet.tv. It says, quote, we share selected information with the following third parties, roadside assistance providers, emergency service providers, all sounds reasonable, law enforcement, other public safety officials, other wireless service providers, your satellite radio provider, credit card processors, data management companies, and others that may be required to provide service, and it goes on. And, of course, insurance companies. Now, listen to me. When you order a pizza, it's run through a criminal database. Everything is. This is the system, and it's not there to protect you. This is there to gauge and track all human activities and feed it into giant algorithms that can predict mass movement activities within 99% accuracy. That's what they admit in the MIT algorithms off the Google Snoop system. They can track individual decisions 93% of the time before you've even consciously thought of what you're going to do. They know what movies you're going to see. They know they're reading your email when you have a Gmail account. That's admitted. All these services. It's not a person doing it. It's computers scanning it, going in your file. This is beyond 1984. They take your baby's blood at birth for 39 years worldwide and put it in a UN database for bioweapons production, you name it, race-specific weapon systems, cancer virus production systems. This is a total scientific dictatorship, 30 to 40 years advanced. Many of the experts I've talked to off record believe that artificial intelligence has probably already been achieved and that most engineers, even top engineers, do not understand one-tenth of the systems they're building and integration, that it's now AI supercomputers. Well, this has got the NSA systems pinging right now. That it's already self-aware AI computers that are actually running it. Let me take you to the next point, ladies and gentlemen, to truly enter the incredible level of information that I'm about to cover here. I meant to get to this yesterday, but I'm glad I waited until today because it dovetails with all the other reports. I just got chills. Yes, Skynet is in control, ladies and gentlemen. Now, oh, you didn't know Skynet's out of a DARPA program from the 60s? That whole movie, that whole system is in-your-face predictive programming. But it isn't going to be machines that strike us. It's the globalist running an automated system that takes human action and decisions out of the equation. Here it is in the Washington Post, Skynet.
HempUSA.org brings you pure camu berry powder. This revolutionary powder contains 50 times the vitamin C of an orange, mixes with any juice or liquid, has 227 servings per container, and is made from naturally grown camu berries, not chemically produced in a laboratory. Order camu berry powder today. Call 908-691-2608 or visit HempUSA.org and see what our powder, seeds, and oil can do for you.
Hi, this is Ted Anderson. Have you ever wondered why banks, stockbrokers, investment advisors won't talk about gold IRAs? They've been available since 1986, yet the financial industry won't recognize the value of gold for your retirement. Gold has outperformed paper investments, yet no word about IRAs. If you would like to have gold for your retirement, call 800-686-2237. Don't get left behind by rising inflation and low returns. Call 800-686-2237. Secure your future and call 1-800-686-2237.
We all know that Berkey water purification systems are the most trusted name in water filtration. As an authorized Berkey dealer for over 6 years and serving thousands of satisfied customers, the Berkey guy offers amazing specials for Berkey water filtration systems. The Berkey light systems include a set of self-sterilizing and recleanable black purification elements that purify water by removing chlorine, pathogenic bacteria, cysts, and parasites to non-detectable levels and remove harmful chemicals such as herbicides and pesticides. Order the Berkey light system today, complete with two black Berkey elements for only $231, and the Berkey guy will ship your order free of charge. With the purchase of a Berkey light, the Berkey guy is also offering a set of fluoride and arsenic filters for only $39.99. That's over 30% off the retail price. Call the Berkey guy at 1-877-886-3653. That's 1-877-886-3653. Or order online at goberkey.com. That's goberkey.com today.
Alex Jones here with vital information concerning our nation's fragile food supply. Folks, there are some truly dangerous trends forming, and I think it's important for my listeners to do three things right away. Number one, study the past. History really does repeat itself. Number two, learn to spot the dangerous food shortage trends. Number three, take decisive action. A perfect storm is brewing, or a global food crisis. That's why I'm telling everyone to read the new book, Rising Prices, Empty Shelves, Warning Signs That Trigger the Deadliest Famines in History. Don't get caught unprepared when the crisis hits. This book is only available at risingprisesemptyshelves.com. You'll also get a free copy of Supermarket Survival, How to Cut Your Grocery Bills in Half. Again, that website is risingprisesemptyshelves.com. That's risingprisesemptyshelves.com.
Optics Planet is calling all hunters, shooters, and outdoorsmen. It's time to gear up. As the best online retailer of rifle scopes, red dot sights, lasers, and other firearm accessories, Optics Planet has a special deal to offer GCN listeners. You may already know OpticsPlanet.com has the best selection of weapon lights, holsters, night vision, binoculars, and tactical gear on the planet. With incredibly low prices, free shipping on most orders, and USA-based phone support, Optics Planet is the online retailer of choice for discerning gun owners and outdoor enthusiasts. Featuring Loophole, Blackhawk, EOTech, Crimson Trace, Night Force, Trigicon, Surefire, over 700 top brands. For a limited time, head to opticsplanet.com/GCN to get a free Streamlight Keymate, the world's most powerful keychain light with purchase. That's opticsplanet.com/GCN or call 800-332-OPTICS right now to speak with an Optics Planet product specialist. 800-332-6784.
Okay, we are back live. Remember, by the late 1970s, orbiting the planet were robotic drones carrying DU head of state decapitation weapons. It is admitted that upwards of 90% of the NASA U.S. space program is classified and military. Never forget this stuff is hidden in plain view. It is admitted that the SR-71 Blackbird, in service in the mid-50s, they're still claiming it's the fastest aircraft they have. It is admitted that the B-2 bomber was in service 20 years before it was announced in the late 1980s and developed decades before that. My father, growing up as a young boy, saw what appeared to be B-2-style bombers flying around in northeast Texas. Now, continuing, so there's this whole other world going on. That's why the system is on such a power trip. That's why they think of you as an animal. It's why they don't care anymore that we're even aware of the fact they're putting cancer viruses in the vaccine. They're playing God. There's a breakaway civilization built with the hundreds and hundreds of trillions of dollars stole that has been stolen from Western taxpayers to build the scientific dictatorship. We're going to be filing more and more detailed reports on this on the radio show and on the nightly news. Now, here is the big news. Document cam, please. For PrisonPlanet.tv viewers. A future for drones, automated killing. Now, again, this has been going on for at least two decades with the automated killing. These are completely automated, pre-programmed with no human activity. And the final phase is being worked on to have robot repair shops on aircraft carriers, mobile factories they can build and set up where humans have to upkeep the systems, but then the robots will take care of the drones and then robots will fully pilot and control the drones themselves. Now, why is this so central? Because they're already using 30-year-old combat swords in Iraq and Afghanistan, combat killer robots. The classified stuff, and I've talked to Marine Corps officers and others, have given me what they can, just like Bob Bowman, former head of Star Wars, has given me what he can for stuff that's up in orbit. They have got killer robots right out of the movies, right out of Terminator, right out of it. And reportedly, they've even got them with the skull faces to freak people out as a psychological warfare development. But mainly, they're tracked vehicles and multi-legged vehicles. There's not two-legged ones. God help us, ladies and gentlemen. They've got declassified mini-tanks that look like something out of a science fiction movie, bristling with guns on them. They've got it all. And this is all designed by the globalists to target the individual, to target the nation, to target the Congress, to target the governors, to target humanity. The chemicals, the biologicals, the drugging of the food and water, the poisoning. It's a full-spectrum dominance system. Okay? All of us are under attack. Every member of the military, every police officer, everybody that serves this in a compartmentalized fashion, every bureaucrat. There is no way to make a deal with this. Its end game is set up the global control grid, and it's growing the tentacles. It's growing the cage right now. Once the cage is in place, the globalists have stated they will begin to release the megadeth bioweapons. We've got to stop it before it gets to that. And exposure of this program is not enough. This is not science fiction. Here's Washington Post. I told you that by 2012, because the Pentagon said this 5 years ago, they would begin to announce this to the public. One afternoon last fall at Fort Benning, Georgia, two model-sized planes took off, climbed 800 and 1,000 feet, and began crisscrossing the military base in search of an orange, green, and blue tarp. The automated, unpiloted planes worked on their own with no human guidance, no hand or any control. For 20 minutes, one of the aircraft carrying a computer processed images from the onboard camera, zeroed in on the tarp, and contacted the second plane, which flew nearby and used its own sensors to examine the colorful object. Then they did the simulated airstrike. Now, you're like, oh, well, those are little craft. They do it scaled down on little cheaper craft, so there's not accidents that people notice, and so it's cheaper, to then upgrade once it's been tested, just like in an air tunnel, up to the next level of medium drone, then high-powered drone. And I've learned from police contacts, and I brought it up to the Austin police chief when he was in here with his aide de camp, and the other guy said, oh, you're right. And Arde Saveda said, I'm here to talk, before they came in. And actually, the little nice guy, jolly Fed act, went away, and he looked at his underling and said, I'm the one doing the talking here. Don't talk. And the guy was like, oh, yes, sir. And I was like, oh, so you got those laser couplers and those big trucks, and You're jacking into federal surveillance grids. The guy's like, yeah, we are, yeah. And the police chief's like, be quiet. He's like, and goes, this is an operative. He's like, my God, you're letting an American patriot know what our op is. Well, you're under attack as well, no matter what you think you've bought into. You'll find out. We'll be right back. Stay with us.
We're on the march. The Empire's on the run. Alex Jones and the GCN Radio Network.
Hi, folks. This is Alex Jones. I'm looking for people that have the wisdom to spot savings, opportunity, and recognize risk. Saving means to make money. The Cowbin Pure Soap Company can save you thousands of dollars and give you good old-fashioned real soaps that are triple concentrated and twice as good as what you're using now. Soaps made from vegetable and coconut oils that contain no useless dyes, perfumes, deodorants, or antibacterials. Your risk is the hundreds of hazardous toxic detergents that give you rashes, itching sores, and deteriorating clothing called lint. If you want something better, if you want something you've never had before, you have to do something you've never done before. Getting a free catalog is easy by calling 800-340-7091 or see Calvin on the web at 5starsoap.com. Take charge of your health now by calling 800-340-7091 or see Calvin on the web at 5starsoap.com.
Tyranny is here. The grim future foretold in 1984 has become reality.
It really says that the state is God.
The United States is now recognized globally as one of the most oppressive police states on Earth. This film conclusively proves the existence of a secret network of FEMA camps, now being expanded nationwide. This documentary exposes how the continuity of government program has established an all-powerful shadow state. Police State 4 chronicles the sickening depths to which our republic has fallen. Prepare to enter the secretive world of emergency dictatorship. Body scanners, sound cameras, citizen spies, stage terror, and cameras on every street corner. It's only the beginning of the New World Order's hellish plan. The police state isn't coming. It's here. Secure your copy today at Infowars.com or see it online in the highest quality at PrisonPlanet.tv.
When you're out on the road, the last place you want to be is on the road. But if the unfortunate happens, you'll be glad you were wearing diamond gussets.
There's a place down in Tennessee where they make blue diamond gusset jeans. They sew pride in every stitch. Guarantee you love the way they fit. Put a diamond gusset in the crotch where you need it most. Blue diamond gussets got it, others don't.
We turn jeans inside out. Diamond gusset jeans. Made in the USA with unparalleled quality. Our Defender motorcycle jeans combine gusset comfort with Kevlar protection so you can ride all day with confidence. Order yours at gusset.com. Diamond gusset jeans got it, others don't.
Talking about Terminator. You know, The Matrix is from a 1970s document that was declassified in 2000. We covered it. I put it in my book, Descent into Tyranny, where they said that their goal by 2025 was to have everyone with a brain chip wired into a central tracking system through the internet that DARPA and the Pentagon invented. And they said that finally they would try to insert everyone into energy tanks, and that we would all become virtual creatures living in pods. And so you see movies like The Matrix, whether they're going to be successful with this or not, that is actually their plan. And of course, that's pretty much what they tell their mid-level people. They plan to just kill everybody and perhaps store the intellect and the essence of some of their favorite minions in The Matrix. You've got Ray Kurzweil running around as their high priest right now, selling transhumanism. That's really neo-eugenics. These are all the false sub-level religions for the people that are truly uninitiated. In the final equation, this is a death cult, a scientific, technocratic death cult. Now, continuing, a future for drones, automated killing. And I want to show you this headline by Peter Finn. And the Pentagon said back in 2002 that by 2012, they wanted half of their ground vehicles, their attack vehicles, and at least half of their aircraft to be fully drone, fully automated, including even many of the troop transport aircraft. And obviously in several states now, like Arizona, they've passed laws allowing Google vehicles, trucks, to be on the roads, and they've been in all sorts of wrecks, and Google has covered all that up and been caught lying about it. That just happened a few weeks ago, another big wreck. The system is going to get behind it and allow it, and then they're going to say, well, the machines, the computers it shows are much safer statistically, and it's going to cut down on deaths on the road, so you're not allowed to drive. And they're going to phase it in. Toyota and others have talked about this with MIT a few years ago, with at first the computer will, when you're 16, not let you drive and track what you're doing and take control and tell you you're making mistakes and also report on you to the police department. That's been announced by Toyota. They're pioneering it. And then they'll just completely phase all of that out. It's all about being bossed at by the technocratic computers. Meanwhile, the drones are flying overhead, the big dirigibles surveilling, ground-penetrating radar, scanning your houses, local police through threat fusion centers, dialing into your phone line, dialing into your cell phone anytime they like. 95% or more of the cops don't know this, but over time they'll all be brought in to be told it, as the public is now being told. Oh, yeah, OnStar's listening to you and tracking everything you're doing. Oh, yeah, Google's doing it. Oh, yeah, there's cameras inside the restrooms and public schools and colleges and rest stops. It's all for your safety. Oh, yes, but we can't stop those drug cartels because we're shipping the drugs in and the guns out. So this is the system. And it's all about dehumanization. They're infecting all the crops with GMO. Even the crops that aren't GMO are being infected by it. Big companies like Monsanto admits that's their program, their plan. They've got thousands of species being crossed together, all sorts of new mutagenic viruses and bacteria being released. UN has been caught dozens and dozens of times in the last year, injecting people with syphilis, polio, hemorrhagic fever, every other nightmare you can imagine, murdering people worldwide, just ongoing death. Massive deaths, illnesses, autoimmune diseases exploding here in the West. Gardasil accounts for 24% of all adverse reactions that are reported for all vaccines combined. And they just run a hoax and get on TV and say not one person's been sick from this, despite the fact that there's thousands of newscasts admitting the carnage. Just, oh, no, no one's been sick, and Dr. Wakefield's been discredited, and blah, blah, blah. None of it's true. WMDs in Iraq. Obama's not going to raise taxes. He's raised scores of different taxes. It's just all a total culture of lies trying to overthrow reality until you just give up. There's another path, though, from just giving up. You can get angry. And if you are listening to my voice, ladies and gentlemen, you are the resistance. Make no mistake. The federal government, of course, more than a decade ago announced, and they're now giving seniors discounts if they'll live in communities from Illinois to Florida to Texas, where everything in the refrigerator is AI surveilled. The people opt in to have elder services monitoring them. This will soon be the nanny state law. Your children will be taken if they're overweight at any level. That's all now being announced. Just total hell being released. All under federal and international regulations. All appliances, all Curly Q, General Electric light bulbs by law have tracker chips in the backs of them so that data over power can go in and access through the plug, through the chip in the machine and track everything you're doing. That's all being announced. They pass that on in cost. Cell phones tracking everything, OnStar tracking everything, total criminal takeover, just absolute total surveillance, end of Bill of Rights, end of everything, poison being put in all the major food lines, water, radioactive isotopes, attacking you and your family. And I'm supposed to sit here and get off on Barack Obama imploding, who he was designed to implode, an ugly, disgusting, demonic puppet meant to destroy hope and change, meant to make you think he was going to bring you hope, and then see the person of hope destroyed in front of you. They rise him up as the image of hope and then destroy hope in front of you so that you have no hope. You understand that? That isn't a victory. This is going along with their event. I don't like Barack Obama, but this was all designed to happen. They're either going to stage terror attacks and make him king, or they could try to assassinate him and turn him into a martyr that way, or they'll flush him down the political toilet and give you a Rick Perry or a Mitt Romney and keep their program rolling. And all these conservatives that have been upset about the imploding economy and the New World Order and all the rest of it, a lot of them are going to roll over once they get a Mitt Romney or Rick Perry in, because they'll have the Democrats attacking them, and they'll get fooled by that. Well, the Democrats, I know, are bad, so if they're attacking Mitt Romney, he must be good. Simple good cop, bad cop parlor tricks. One of the oldest roadside carriage jacking, coach jacking, and then later carjacking systems is to have a woman broke down on the side of the road. And you pull over and her husband walks over and she acts like she's estranged. And then she jumps in the car with you and you let her in and she pulls a gun on you. And that's all that is. Oh, look, Obama's being attacked by the Republicans. Democrats, he must be good, even though he's nailing us to the wall. Oh, look, Mitt Romney's being attacked by the Democrats. He must be good. Elementary mind games. Elementary. And if you can't see through those, you don't have a hope or a prayer. But by waking up and by admitting how sick it is and taking on the reality, the full, burning, disgusting reality. You guys pull up Patrick Henry quote, as for me, I will know the whole truth and make preparation for it. Just Patrick Henry quote, I will know the whole truth and make preparation for it. That should pull up the full quote. You see, the truth's already right there, even if you refuse to admit it's there. You can delusionally walk out on the top of a 50-story hotel and climb to the top and jump off and say, I'm a bird. But if you don't have a parachute, you're dead when you hit the bottom. You're dead. Deader than a doornail. So see, that reality is there. That 50-story drop is there, even if you're on PCP and not knowing reality and are like, I'm a skylark. I'm a butterfly. Is this the part of wise men engaged in a great and arduous struggle for liberty? Are we disposed to be of the number of those who, having eyes, see not, and having ears, hear not, the things which so nearly concern their temporal salvation? For my part, whatever anguish of spirit it may cost, I am willing to know the whole truth, to know the worst, and to provide for it. Do me a favor, that's the gimme liberty or gimme death speech. We print that little jewel, that little succulent jewel of awakening and rebellion against tyranny for me. You see, I understand the scientific dictatorship. I read the declassified white papers by the hundreds over the years. They tell us what they're going to do. Last night, I showed Rockefeller Foundation in 68 and 66 saying we've started to develop sterilants to be added to the vaccines. And I have the report from 85. We've made great steads. We've made great accomplishments. Time to roll it out on the public. I'm willing to go to the Rockefeller Foundation documents at the UT Library. I'm willing to read what they say they're doing to me. I'm willing to put my name, my body, my family up against these people, because there's no future if we don't beat them. This is not a fight you choose or don't choose to join. You either lay down and say, I'm going to be delusional and serve evil and decide not to see this, or you commit to fight it. Everybody's got a sixth sense. Everybody's got a gut. And everybody I talked to for years has been completely freaked out and just feeling dread. And the globalists are masters. They know you're already having that feeling. Your subconscious mind, 1,000 times more powerful than the conscious, knows all the truth, sees it all, sees how fake it all is. Your conscious mind has decided to lie to you because you're scared. You're acting like a child in denial, a woman who just faints in the face of something so ugly. A man who faints. You're psychologically fainting. They won't get you out of the jam. And the globalists know you're afraid. So they say, you know why you're having that anxiety? This man with a turban. And people are like, yeah, man, I'm scared of him. But deep down, you know, that's not who I'm scared of. That's not who makes my heart go pitter-patter. It's the evil. Your mind is so powerful, it's scanning the poison. Your olfactory nerve, when you drink that tap water and it and that taste and rolls over your taste buds, your subconscious is like, what are you doing? Don't do it. I remember as a child drinking Dallas tap water, and it tasted like kerosene. And I remember how it'd make me get a headache, and how when I'd brush my teeth with fluoride, I'd get a headache, and I'd lay on the couch, and I'd never heard fluoride was bad, and I knew. And I remember one of my parents is saying, is there some kind of other toothpaste that makes me sick? Just like when I was 5, 6 years old and was carbon monoxide all over the road because they didn't have catalytic converters yet, and I'd get sick driving into Dallas, I'd say, I don't want to go into Dallas. I don't want to be in traffic. I don't want, you know, to drive into to work with Dad today, you know, because it was a holiday or something. I don't want to breathe all that. I didn't know what carbon monoxide was. I just knew 5, 6, 7 years old, I got sick driving into work. We lived outside Dallas, on the edge of Dallas. We drive into Dallas. I mean, come on, folks. You can taste food when it's rotten, can't you? When you drink milk and it's rotten. Don't you have any survival instincts? Look, I understand men that love football. I understand people that are into things like that. But that's a simulation of a tribe, of an army, of your men you're rooting for who are going out there and fighting the enemy. And it punches buttons in your brain that are about survival. It's simulated war. And, you know, I've taken my son out. He's really good at swimming and other sports, but I never spent much time with him on football, so he's, you know, not that good at it. And I watch these dads who are just incredibly competitive and crazy-eyed and really, you know, into it competitively, but almost in a sick way. And they, you know, they go to the go to schools and things I've seen, because my children are only in school twice a week. They're homeschool, but then they're in regular school. Well, it's like a homeschool slash school twice a week. And dads come off work on recess to play football and get all serious. And it's like, what if the dad was serious about knowing what's in his children's water? What if they were serious about the legislature and using that warfare memory, that warfare program, that warfare system on real warfare in the modern battlefield? Not getting real serious about this is war, this is success on this football. That's a simulation to shunt all of your male energies off into something that doesn't matter. And you see men at football games. Occasionally I'll go to one, and they're strutting in, and they're sitting down, and they're feeling manly, getting their endorphins going for combat, to watch simulated combat. Meanwhile, there's drones flying above you. Meanwhile, they're militarizing the police against you. Meanwhile, they're garnering enemy databases and files on every man, woman, and child in this country. Meanwhile, there's a scientific murder system set up, and I've got to watch men run around like little children and let their children be groped and violated as prisoners so they can have the so-called American pastime of bringing their children into a football game and paying $10 for an iced tea or $7 for a hot dog and being ripped off while a bunch of swollen steroid human growth hormone heads run around and fight with each other, and you teach your children that's who you idolize. Not Thomas Jefferson, not George Washington, not trailblazers, not firefighters that go into burning buildings, not mathematicians. And you wonder why 100 years ago in America, trailblazers were our heroes. Scientists were our heroes. And so we had the greatest scientists, the most wealth, and the highest test scores. Now our heroes are, at best, men who can put a ball in a basket. And again, at a primitive level, that goes back to the Greek games of who could run a marathon the best. I understand being into athleticism and being into human exaltation in energy and how far can humans drive each other. But physically is an ancient caveman system. You know, I see men constantly putting themselves into positions to feel physically powerful. And that's important, because when you produce those hormones with the exercise, it will also develop the others associated with higher thinking. But the real war is for the mind. The real war is in understanding reality. And reality is so much wilder. The general public is in a false, stunted, shut down, tiny spectrum of reality. A very small Madison Avenue advertisement system. What it is to be a woman, what it is to be a man, what goals are in life. People are taught to feel unfulfilled. People are taught to trust the system, the drug ads, all of it. It is a scientific global domination system. And all cultures attempted to dominate every other group around them. And the most popular form of total domination was total extermination. In every culture, Aztec, Roman, Jewish, Chinese, it doesn't matter. Vandal, Visigoth. Here's one, Daily Mail. War on the Red Empire. How America planned for an attack on Britain in the 1930s with bombing raids and chemical weapons. The plan was green-lighted, but then finally when he got in office, Roosevelt said no. But the U.S. war planners wanted a way to get the United States and the Department of War, as before they used better psychological warfare and call it the Department of Defense, and a plan to take over the British Empire and set up world government themselves. That is in the Daily Mail today. And yes, they were going to nerve gas most of the people in England. And of course, that was at a time when they were talking about making a deal with Herr Hitler, which we tell you about in Endgame. But the decision was made instead to side with the Fabian Socialist. Be right back.
What you're about to hear are the real experiences of women over 40 who finally lost weight by becoming hormonally balanced again.
I lost 20 pounds.
I lost 40 pounds.
I lost 55 pounds.
I went from a size 14 to a size 8.
Their secret is Amberen, the revolutionary formula for women over 40 that balances hormones naturally. The leading cause of weight gain over 40 is hormonal imbalance. Until you balance your hormones, losing weight can be practically impossible. But Amberen restores hormonal balance naturally, so the weight can just fall right off, even that stubborn belly fat. Plus, Amberen eliminates other symptoms of hormonal aging, like hot flashes, night sweats, low libido, difficulty concentrating, and more. Be one of the first 50 callers right now, and they'll send you a complimentary risk-free trial with a 30-day supply. Free. Call 1-800-737-9107. That's 1-800-737-9107. 1-800-737-9107.
You don't need me to tell you that humanity is in a deep crisis. Everyone can feel it. We know a tectonic struggle is now taking place between the forces of freedom and those who love darkness, bondage, and enslavement. Yes, my friends, evil is rising. But take heart, for every action, there is an equal and opposite reaction. Recently, New World Order operative Hillary Clinton admitted they're losing the info war.
We are in an information war, and we are losing that war.
The globalists are scared. They've overreached. The future of the info war is in your hands. Join PrisonPlanet.tv. Download the thousands of special video reports, ebooks, and more, and get them out to everyone you know. Continue to spread the word about the broadcast on YouTube, Facebook, Twitter, and every other globalist propaganda platform. We are going to use their system against them. The info war now goes into high gear.
Calling all shooters, OpsGear.com is your source for targets and head-to-toe tactical gear. This week only, radio listeners save 25% on our exclusive shooting targets. We've got training targets, 3D targets, Zombie Osama, and our exclusive real threat targets. Check them out at OpsGear.com. Use coupon code GCN at checkout. That's GCN and save 25% on all OpsGear targets. Plus, we give away great gear each week. Visit us at OpsGear.com. That's OPSGEAR.com or call 888-239-1384.
We the People grow cotton, weave fabric, engrave ink, embed strips and fibers to protect from counterfeit, then carting to a private bank, having it lent back at interest, forcing taxes to service debt. This capitalism, or was Jefferson correct when stating a central bank issuing the public currency is a greater menace to the liberties of the people than a standing army? Hi, Ted Anderson. I'm placing a free silver dollar in a book that explains our monetary system. Call for your copy, 800-686-2237. It's time to understand the system. Call 800-686-2237. That's 800-686-2237.
Kurt Haskell, survivor of the underwear Christmas Day bomber, who's been going to the trial of the mind control minion, Mutallab, is going to be joining us with breaking news in the first 30 minutes of the third hour. Then the head of Euro-Pacific Capital, who's really been extremely accurate on calling what would take place in the economy. Peter Schiff is going to be joining us because I want to get his take on the stock market plunging today. We'll continue to watch that and track that, get into the politics section of the news. I do want to get into some of the big developments over in the Middle East, but I also want to take your calls in the next hour on any of the subjects I've raised. But does it concern you? Here's the headline, Washington Post, a future for drones, automated killing. See, it's not enough to have a zit-faced 20-year-old 8,000 miles away sitting there giggling, eating Hot Pockets and drinking Diet Coke, and I've seen that on the news, dropping bombs on a whole wedding party to kill one person. Disconnected from the killing, very manly. Well, now you're going to be taken completely out of the equation, and it's going to be automated. And then the globalists don't need you. And their big goal is to have a big enough drone fleet where they can have the robots load the bio or chem weapon and then deploy it against you. And again, the Sunshine Project 12 years ago got declassified documents that the Marine Corps then contacted them. Those documents are posted on their archive. They've since shut down due to threats, but the website's still up. We need to get the former head of the Sunshine Project on. In fact, I'm going to have Doo do that. That's important for the TV show. I know it was based out of Austin. And it said, the Army and Marine Corps are working on drone programs for lethal and non-lethal drones to knock out whole cities. Just like, this wasn't a drill. You can read the Daily Mail. It's now been declassified. 70-plus years later, from the mid-1930s, a plan to nerve gas England and its other islands and take over the empire. See, this is what governments do. This is what militaries do. That's like in third world countries. You always hear about the military overthrowing the government. It ends up happening 100% of the time. Long enough in Asia, Africa, or Latin America. It happens 100% of the time in every other system. It just happens within a few decades in third world countries. It always happens within 200 years of any system. Oh, except for America. 230 plus. We've got the record. But it's already gone. We just think the Republic's still here. By admitting it's gone, we can get it back because it's not a living thing. It's eternal. It's an idea. It can be resurrected. But you have to breathe life into it. And it does take the blood, sweat, and tears of patriots. You don't have a future without committing and fighting this, okay? I want to get that across to people. There is no decision. There is a decision, but it's a sick joke. You can be delusional and decide to go along with this system, or you can decide to research what I've said and find out it's true. And then I have enough respect in you that you're going to find ways to beat these people. There's a million ways to skin a cat. We're going to hit them from every angle. There's only a few thousand of these globalists. So that's all coming up, and they've got more articles about drones. U.S. drone bases in Africa to focus on Al-Qaeda. In North Africa, they put Al-Qaeda in Libya. That's how dumb the globalists think you are. That's London Guardian. Before I go to breaking in this hour, don't forget InfoWars Nightly News. We're going to send out the entire show, including an interview that I didn't air last night because we ran out of time with Dr. Wakefield, the second part of it, today after the show, to anybody who signed up at InfoWars Insider. Go to InfoWars.com to InfoWars Insider, right up there at the top. You can see the little banner, InfoWars Insider. Put your email in, click subscribe. We'll send you last night's incredible transmission on eugenics. A full spectrum breakdown in an hour of current murdering of foster children in the U.S. with chemical and biological testing on them. What's going in the vaccines and more, InfoWars Insider. And if you're not a subscriber to PrisonPlanet.tv, we're going to be on tonight, 7 o'clock. Stay with us. We'll be right back.
This is GCN, the Genesis Communications Radio Network.
Hello, friends. Alex Jones here. You all know I've worked for years with Steve Shank and eFoods Direct. I have eFoods for my own emergency food supply. You know, Steve, life is different now for all of us, isn't it?
Very different. People are using this great food to survive the present hurricane season, and we've already had $40 billion worth of damage from floods, storms, quakes, and droughts. And that's just the first 8 months of this year. Natural disasters are newsworthy, but only touch a few of us Americans. The huge issue of the greatest depression recession is on everyone's mind. The unemployment, the loss of homes, lost businesses, and skyrocketing food costs are hitting every American. So everyone needs food security.
Folks, this month you will get free shipping on every food order from eFoods Direct. That's right. Every order gets free shipping starting September 6th. Get stocked up with the best storable foods out there with eFoods Direct and be prepared for any emergency before it happens. To take advantage of this special, call 800-409-5633 or go to eFoodsDirect.com/Alex.
Waging war on corruption. Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. Big Brother. Mainstream media. Government cover-ups. You want answers? Well, so does he. He's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. And now, live from Austin, Texas, Alex Jones.
All right, we got Bible studies getting shut down all over the country by Big Brother. Total violation of the First Amendment and freedom of assembly. We got Dow plunging 400 points. Global markets tumble 4%. Zolik over there at the World Bank, good little globalist, says the world is in danger zone. Soros, U.S. already in double dip. How about already in a depression? We never left the recession, and anybody who runs any type of business with employees knows that. So that's all coming up. I want to give out the toll-free number to join us on air. It's 800-259-9231. Notice our phones are loading up without me giving the number out. 800-259-9231. I've been talking about the fact that they're going to go to fully automated military that's robot. Air, land, and sea, so the globalists can just do whatever they want, pre-program their armies, then have some technicians that help when the robots can't fix the other robots. This is the pure evil of the New World Order. Can anybody in the military see where this is going? Anybody see this? I'd like to get your take on it. That and other issues we've raised here today. Let's talk to Brad in Texas. You're on the air.
Hey, Alex. I'm active duty military. I'm just traveling through Texas right now. Just wanted to talk to you. I recently left California at a base that we had protesters outside would constantly be protesting against drone warfare. And they really had a big push. They did not like them out there at all. They constantly sent out emails on a regular basis trying to prepare people, tell them, do not talk. Don't tell them anything. Point them towards your public relations rep. And they would demonize them, calling them terrorists for staging outside the base, letting people know their opinions about, drone warfare, killing millions of Iraqis in Afghanistan and Iraq.
Well, sir, I've seen documents where patriots have been called terrorists for even protesting the Federal Reserve, but I would love to see those base emails. If you've got them in your inbox and can send them to us, that would be important news for folks to hear that protesters outside the base, they were actually calling them terrorists.
Well, they didn't say so in the email. Actually, I worked with the police there on base, and they would constantly have riot training. They would have big training groups where they would openly talk about them being terrorists. I didn't have actually any documents saying that they were on paper, but we would constantly get emails just preparing us for the confrontation with this group called Code Pink. And I think it's a fantastic thing that they were doing out there, trying to raise awareness of...
I don't agree with the Code Pink's attack on the Second Amendment and things, but they are brave, and drones are a war crime. When they use them in built-up areas, their favorite thing is a wedding or a family meeting, and they've said it's collateral damage. We'll kill 200 innocent people, including children, to, quote, kill one combatant because they're Al-Qaeda. And then meanwhile, they're in the news today. I read this headline earlier where they're saying they're secretly deploying, London Guardian, drones all over North Africa, and as we said they would, using Libya as a base for the drones, those big airports there, to fight Al-Qaeda when our own government just gave Libya to Al-Qaeda. That's how dumb they think we are. Do you have any comments on that, sir? All All right, we lost Brad. Thank you, Brad. Yeah, here's the Washington Post. U.S. assembling secret drone bases in Africa, Arabian Peninsula officials say. Here's another one. U.S. drone bases in Africa to focus on Al-Qaeda targets in Somalia. Oh, that's so sick. Everything's Al-Qaeda, except Al-Qaeda. Our government isn't run by good people. It's run by outside ruthless banks who've got a whole secret technological system under their control, and they're getting rid of the last factors of human decision-making. I want to hear from more military people and others. Are you concerned about the globalists having their own drone robot army?
You've heard Alex explain how the Silver Lungs generator infuses the respiratory system with your self-produced colloidal silver solutions, yet many are unaware of the entire function of the Silver Lungs system and how it has been designed to deliver your silver solutions anywhere in or on the body. My name is Mario Cifaldi, and I'm the developer of the Silver Lungs generator. Not only does the Silver Lungs system produce endless colloidal and ionic silver solutions, it also comes equipped with the proper applicators and devices needed to deliver your silver solutions directly to key target areas. This includes the eyes, ears, nose, lungs, topically to the skin, and orally for the digestive system. Be sure to watch our new 7-minute video tour of the Silver Lungs system at www.silverlungs.com to learn more about how the Silver Lungs system works. As well, we are always ready to answer any questions you may have. That's www.silverlungs.com.
Alex Jones here with vital information concerning our nation's fragile food supply. Folks, there are some truly dangerous trends forming, and I think it's important for my listeners to do three things right away. Number one, study the past. History really does repeat itself. Number two, learn to spot the dangerous food shortage trends. Number three, take decisive action. A perfect storm is brewing, or a global food crisis. That's why I'm telling everyone to read the new book, Rising Prices, Empty Shelves. Warning signs that trigger the deadliest famines in history. Don't get caught unprepared when the crisis hits. This book is only available at risingprisesemptyshelves.com. You'll also get a free copy of Supermarket Survival, How to Cut Your Grocery Bills in Half. Again, that website is risingprisesemptyshelves.com. That's risingprisesemptyshelves.com.
Hi, folks. This is Alex Jones. I'm looking for people that have the wisdom to spot savings, opportunity, and recognize risk. Saving means to make money. The Cowbin Pure Soap Company can save you thousands of dollars and give you good old-fashioned real soaps that are triple concentrated and twice as good as what you're using now. Soaps made from vegetable and coconut oils that contain no useless dyes, perfumes, deodorants, or antibacterials. Your risk is the hundreds of hazardous toxic detergents that give you rashes, itching sores, and deteriorating clothing called lint. If you want something better, if you want something you've never had before, you have to do something you've never done before. Getting a free catalog is easy by calling 800-340-7091 or see Calvin on the web at 5starsoap.com. Take charge of your health now by calling 800-340-7091 or see Calvin on the web at 5starsoap.com.
He's the T-Rex of political talk. Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network.
All 50 states are in the process of passing or have already passed laws, and the feds have already opened the way up for that as well, to have Google cars driving people and products, 18-wheelers, buses, you name it. And in the MIT and Toyota analysis that I read a decade ago on air to you, and again the last few years, they said everyone in a car will be watched by the police department. You can pull this up even in CBS News. For safety, via the cell phone system that's now being put in most cars, even if you don't have OnStar, it's being built in as the new emergency system. And all that data is uploaded in real time to the feds, sent to the threat fusion centers. And everything is to be remote control. And it's already here. So prepare yourself for that. These cars are already on the road all over, having wrecks, crashing into people. Globalists don't care. They're going to run it until it does have a higher safety standard than human driving, and then they're going to get rid of human driving. And that's all been announced. That's all coming. And, of course, LaHood, the head of the Transportation Department, said, we are anti-car. We're going to try to shut down the use of cars unless they are robotic. And this is how it's going to be phased in, to where basically aircraft pilots will just be like a toilet attendant there in case there's a problem. Same thing with people driving buses and trains and cars. It will be entirely ceremonial. Some of the other news that we have here, U.S. lawmakers will see gruesome reality of China's one-child policy. Cyber News Service is reporting they're going to have congressional hearings about how they have forced abortions and kill babies that have already been born. But this is all hailed by the UN, Planned Parenthood, and others. And Obama has supported these policies. So has, of course, the vice president. And this has all been financed by the people that run our country in the deals that they signed back in the 1970s with the Chi-Coms. Continuing Fukushima fallout is in California rainwater. And that's ABC News finally reporting some reality. We're going to be going over some of that. Five killed in typhoon, batters, tsunami ravaged Japanese coast. Obviously, the stock markets are tumbling right now. Dow plunges 400 points. Global markets tumble 4%. Zolik, world in danger zone. The answer is set up the new bank of the world that's already been set up with SDRs, but publicly have Europe sign over dictatorial power to it. Our Congress, our super Congress, to sign dictatorial power over to it. And the very bankers that have maneuvered us to this point always say, give us more power, we'll fix it. And then things get worse. Give us more power, we'll fix it. And then things get worse. Give us more power, we'll fix it. Things get worse. Give us more power, we'll fix it. Give us more power, give us more power, give us more power. And even though you're awake to them, they're like, we know you're waking up. Do you notice the SWAT teams and the drones, the threat fusion centers, and that we're tracking people? Okay, yes, we're criminals. Sit down and take it. And so that's how this works. And most people just say, well, I'm going to go along to get along for my 20, 30 pieces of silver. Soros says U.S. already in double dip. Ladies and gentlemen, we have been in a depression for at least the last 3.5 years. Another headline, global meltdown, investors dumping everything. This is the big news of what's happening today. We've also got these articles up at Infowars.com and PrisonPlanet.com. It's also all up at DrudgeReport.com. Global meltdown. And I told you, as soon as they got the next round of bailouts in Europe, this would begin. It was all planned. Investors are dumping nearly everything. With no solution in sight for Europe and new fears of global recession, investors dumped stocks and commodities and ran to the safety of U.S. treasuries, themselves being mainly bought by the private Federal Reserve, now propping up their investment. Treasury yields, as a result, slipped to historic lows with a 10-year yield at 1.75%, the 30-year at 2.68. And again, this is not the dollar rising. This is it being the last bastion. All the people are running to what they see as the biggest piece of wreckage. This is the command destruction model. The dollar was also beneficiary of a massive fear trade. Since the U.S. stock sharply lower on the heels of steep sell-offs in equities markets around the globe. The worst performing stock sectors mirrored the sell-off in global commodities markets with materials down 4.46. I thought this was a great boon in our economy. Obama had all the answers. They did have the answers. Destroy our economy by design. And energy stocks down to 4.1%. Copper hit by concerns of Chinese slowdown. See, they've got a global inflation happening, but they're depressing the real economy while inflating the currency, trying to balance the two in a double whammy against the general population, only to help the mega rich and the central banks. See, all policies are to consolidate power in them. Your money's inflated, but there's also a overall depression. And so that puts the damper on prices going up. That's why you're going to see gold, silver, copper all plunge. For now, they'll only rocket back up if you follow this economic witch's brew. Gold, usually a safety play, was sold into the maelstrom as investors raised cash. But see, what happens then in the next phase is, again, the dollar starts to devalue and retrogrades. And then the euro spikes. It's a seesaw designed by the insiders with insider manipulation to continue to shear us down to the bone. The euro also fell a recent bottom of its range and is trading in the 1.346 area, an eight-month low against the dollar. But if you watch the long-term trends, both are dropping. But then they spike each other up and down against each other to create the illusion of volatility, but it's short-term. People are finding it really isn't gold. It isn't precious metals. It's not currencies. U.S. treasuries are where people are flocking to at a time of extreme concern about risk because the United States has the globalists running it, the banksters running it, and has the tens of thousands of nuclear weapons, the drones, everything. And that's basically the whole hostage program. As we continue to see treasuries continue to get bid up, said Zane Brown, fixed income strategist at Lord Abbott. The selling in risk assets picked up momentum after the Fed's statement Wednesday, in which it characterized risk in the economy as significant and noted that strains in global financial markets on Europe could be the catalyst. The overnight preliminary China manufacturing data showed moderating growth, which again will start to drive down commodities because that's the big producer. All in a managed economy working with the Chinese. Now, I want to go to your phone calls. I just want to remind people that right now they're telling Europe, you will give all of your power that's left. You've already given your sovereignty over to the euro. Now, the euro is going to give it all to a new financial union. They call it the United States of Europe, but there's no republic, there's no voting, there's no freedom. It's a bureaucracy of bankers running everything, announcing increased taxes, cutting all the benefits, not to pay anything off, it's an impossible black hole, but to destroy the economies. And now they have to have the Federal Reserve and others come out and say, oh my gosh, it's a panic, to cause a panic, as we said they would do last week and a month before that and a month before that. We're now entering this zone, just like 2008. They said blood in the streets, martial law, total collapse if you don't give the bankers unlimited trillions. Same thing happened. Total collapse if you don't create a super Congress to decide monetary policy. No longer does that come out of the regular House and Senate. Now it's a super Congress, all getting us ready for the fall and winter implosion that we predicted 2 months ago with the super Congress. Everything is about a dictatorial system with all the talking heads telling us they're going to fix it. And then you give them the dictatorship and they'll stop fear-mongering. The stocks will go back up for a while. And then a year or two down the road, they'll start it again to get more power. But always sliding into a deeper depression. Every time they want more power, they plunge it even more. You give up your liberties, they let it go back up a tiny bit to a new low, then a new plateau, then they plunge it again, and that's the power cycle. It's very elementary. Let's go to another phone call here. Let's talk to Pastor in Ohio. Welcome, sir.
Yeah, Alex, how you doing?
I'm doing all right.
Good. Hey, the reason I called, you know, the only time I call is if I have any information.
You're one of the fellows that gave us the documents that FEMA was recruiting preachers secretly to spy on their flock and tell them to go to FEMA camps and turn their guns in. And a couple years after you gave us those documents, it became mainstream news. Yes, sir.
Okay. Well, first of all, you was talking about the Bible studies, and the last time I was on here, I was telling you about, you know, the different things that's happening in churches. Churches, for the most part, are getting people in, but they're no more than coming in, and they're turning around and leaving when they find out they can't get a handout. So churches are actually losing people and losing money. They're doing everything they can to keep them in there, but people are finding out that they're being indoctrinated from the pulpit. And with shows like yours and you know, others like, you know, Steve Quell and George Norrie, and they're listening to people. They're starting to listen. You would not believe the number of people that listen to you just in the area that I am in. And I find that out just through simple conversation, and the next thing you know, your name comes up. And if your name doesn't come up, well, then I'm always one of the first ones to make sure it does, because I'll mention it myself. And
well, I was in Hot Springs, Arkansas, and I wasn't out in public a lot. I probably had about 20 people come up to me while I was there. And again, that's just an illustration of how many people are awake and listening to just this show. I mean, the fact is we reach a regular 3 million people a day or so. But overall, conservatively, we reach about 10 million new people a week. And that's our real mission. A lot of people just brush into us, you know, a few hundred times in a year or even a few times in a month. But it's irrevocable information they get because then they never thought of it from that angle. And then it all makes sense. I can't tell you how many generals, how many colonels, how many ad executives, how many doctors say nothing made sense till I heard your show. Well, of course it makes sense. I'm not smart. I read globalist white papers. Pastor, stay there. Have you finish up? Then we're going to go to Jason, Tim, David, Severin, and others. I'm Alex Jones, Infowars.com, PrisonPlanet.tv. We'll be back tonight, of course, 7 o'clock Central.
Hey guys, are weaker testosterone levels taking you out of the game? Are you gaining fat, feeling tired, losing desire in the bedroom? Get back in the game. Call now for a risk-free trial of Ageless Male, a natural supplement shown to raise testosterone by 61% and maintain healthy, normal levels. No injections, no appointments. Just take Ageless Male every day and boost your testosterone by 61%. When your levels are healthy, you can feel energy again, a great outlook again, and yes, a healthy sex drive. The results are life-changing. Beware of cheap knockoffs. Ageless Male is an exclusive formula and the only one proven in research to boost testosterone 61%. Try Ageless Male, risk-free. Just call 1-800-497-8345. 1-800-497-8345. 1-800-497-8345.
From the shattered Rust Belt come the Lost Vegas.
Well, I think it's a little weird to talk about revolution over the themes and memes of corporate-produced and approved music. I'm Tony Yetzer from the Las Vegas. We produced and approved our own recordings on Life Before the Collapse, and then we put it on vinyl because it sounds good. Take care. Drinking too much coffee.
Life Before the Collapse by the Lost Vegas on 180-gram vinyl and mastered especially for vinyl by legendary audio engineer Steve Hall. Life Before the Collapse by the Lost Vegas.
The Lost Vegas.
Now available at Amazon.com.
Hello, I'm Alex Jones. Myself, my family, the Infowars.com team want to relay to you and your families that we are intensifying our efforts against the globalist on every front. Infowars.com is leading the fight against the technocrats. But we can't do that without your help. By getting the films, bumper stickers, and t-shirts at Infowars.com, you will wake up people in your area and support our operation as we move to the next level. We need your help to spread the word like never before. They wish to hide themselves during this tectonic battle between the forces of freedom and darkness. You are the response to the globalist technocrats and their program of global eugenics dehumanization and ultimate extermination. The war is here. It's an info war. The spirit of 1776 versus the mindset of 1984.
They're poisoning the water with fluoride. They're spraying the air with heavy metals. Why and what can you do to defend your family? This week at waterwebinar.com, in an all-new free live online webinar, Earth's most powerful cleansing secret is being revealed. A secret they don't want you to know about. Find out how to take fluoride and heavy metals out of your water and your body. Use it to neutralize deadly inorganic particles like lead, aluminum, even mercury, and remove these accumulated poisons from your body. Go to waterwebinar.com, a water secret. Secret so powerful, some have called it the number one threat to the entire New World Order health agenda. It was even used during Chernobyl to clean up nuclear contamination. Go to waterwebinar.com now and sign up for free to find out how to turn the worst water on this planet into pristine, clear drinking water which heals your body. You can take your water freedom into your own hands and defend yourself and your family from the globalist health agenda. Don't get left behind. It's your life, your water, your freedom. Fight for it. Go to waterwebinar.com now.
We'll be right back.
cult of personality. The cult of personality. People like Barack Obama, George Bush. The system wants you to focus on them so they can be politically destroyed and have the globalist agenda blamed on them. Well, I don't like captains of the New World Order, but I'd rather go after the generals, the field marshals, the dark lords, the owners of the corrupt system that think I'm their property. I'm not. And we have a right, universal common law, to resist this attack. But 90% of it is psychological. There is a war on for your mind. Break their conditioning. Become aware of the manipulation. Because from this tyranny, there is no coming back. If we allow these people to take over, they want to give us no quarter. They want full spectrum, total dominance. And that means extermination. If you don't know history, that is the norm. It's just been declassified. The U.S. government planned to nerve gas most of England, killing the population, and to nerve gas the islands and different continents that the British controlled to take over the British Empire. Instead, a deal was made to absorb the British Empire and to double-cross Hitler. The deal had been made to overthrow Roosevelt, link up with Hitler, and take out the British. There is an article out on this today out of the Daily Mail. And if I have time later, I want to get to that because it was here in my stack and now I can't find it. I'll find it in a moment. And it's kind of a whitewash, but it does admit it. So I think I'll go a bit more into that, or perhaps tonight I'll talk about it on the nightly news. Let's go ahead and go back to Pastor in Ohio. So, Pastor, what was the point you were going to make today?
Okay, the point I was going to make today, like I was telling you, people are leaving churches and they're forming their own Bible studies and they're learning more and more of the truth about the Bible, you know, this rapture theory and everything else. The other thing I wanted to tell you about is this, and I got not only do I have documentation that I got off of someone about this, but I also got this by word of mouth, face-to-face with an individual that is a part of this. You see, there are groups, I just wrote it down what he said, there are groups in place that once an event happens, whether, you know, we get attacked again or whatever the case may be, they're already in place to keep the Constitution in place, but there are those who want to take it completely out and totally change it. Obama's behind all that, but it's not...
Well, let me stop you. Look, it's the cover of Time Magazine, Newsweek in the last 6 months. Time to get rid of the Constitution. It's bad. It caused the problems. Get rid of all the freedoms. The bankers will give you money. You know, in Europe, get rid of all your sovereignty. We'll give you money. Again, they hold you hostage. It's why they've been trying to take over forever, and they're basically to that point. So, yes, I mean, we have a government and its whore media telling us to get rid of the Constitution. The founders explained that. That's treason.
And not only that, Alex, that you got, just for lack of a different way of announcing them, you have the white hats and you have the black hats. And the white hats are the one that are in the government and in different high places and other places that are military that are making sure that if anything goes down, you know, they don't know, people don't know who other people are, but they are in place trying to do everything they can to keep things in place. But I will tell you this, they told me that over 80%+ of the U.S. troops have already stated or shown in one way or another, whether they've been on drills or whatever, that they will not fire on American citizens. And that has these black hats, so-called, very, very upset.
I know. Here's the problem, though. What they'll do is, and we've seen this from past actions in other countries, they'll commit massacres and then say that the Patriots did it. They'll string cops up, you name it, and then say that we did it. Well, just like they say Ron Paul's calling for violence and I'm calling for violence on MSNBC with that Rise of the New Right special they did. And the police and military have got to be smart when this goes down. And they've got to go investigate themselves and find out that it's going to be private mercenaries that are actually doing it. They're going to dress up foreign mercenaries and others like constitutionalists and commit all manner of atrocity. And that's just standard false flag deception. And so we've got to be aware of that, and people have got to understand this. Anything else?
Yes, sir. They are going to convert the American people, and even and first, and then the other people throughout the rest of the world, to their way of thinking by offering new technology.
They're going you're absolutely. Oh, is this what you were told by your source? I want to hear more about it on the other side.
We're on the march. The empire's on the run. Alex Jones and the GCN Radio Network.
A very wealthy U.S. citizen is predicting that in 2011, we will witness the most important day in America in more than 50 years. He says it will change everything about our lives. The way you shop, travel, invest, educate your children, and even how you take care of your health and your own family. Now, this man has made some outrageous predictions over the years. The crazy part is, he's usually right. You see, he predicted the collapse of GM, Fannie Mae, Freddie Mac, and America's biggest mall owner, General Growth Properties. In fact, Barron's called his work a dire prophecy. Recently, he created a video, which you can watch online for free, detailing his biggest and most important prediction yet, and it's a real eye-opener. I can't stress this enough. You should at least watch this free video online today. He explains everything you need to know, including simple steps you can take to protect yourself. You can find the video at www.endofamerica3.com. That's endofamerica3.com. Watch the free video at www.endofamerica3.com. That's endofamerica3.com.
Hello, friends. Alex Jones here. You all know I've worked for years with Steve Shank and eFoods Direct. I have eFoods for my own emergency food supply. You know, Steve, life is different now for all of us, isn't it?
Very different. People are using this great food to survive the present hurricane season, and we've already had $40 billion worth of damage from floods, storms, quakes, and droughts. And that's just the first 8 months of this year. Natural disasters are newsworthy, but only touch a few of us Americans. The huge issue of the Greatest Depression is on everyone's mind. The unemployment, the loss of homes, lost businesses, and skyrocketing food costs are hitting every American. So everyone needs food security.
Folks, this month you will get free shipping on every food order from eFoods Direct. That's right. Every order gets free shipping starting September 6th. Get stocked up with the best storable foods out there with eFoods Direct and be prepared for any emergency before it happens. To take advantage of this special, call 800-409-5633 or go to eFoodsDirect.com/Alex.
Hundreds of nations have fallen to tyranny in the last century alone. This is our last chance to not relive history.
As we're finishing off this agenda, they'll be pulling the rug from underneath Americans at home.
They have tremendous influence on our president and Congress, and they really are calling the shots.
I think it's incumbent upon all of us as American citizens to pay attention.
Fall of the Republic identifies the enemies of our nation, the criminal offshore cartel, hell-bent on destroying sovereignty and on its ashes constructing world government.
Tim Geithner, Bernanke, they're arsonists. They're asking for more matches. And the Congress is saying, who do we make the check out to?
Today seems like nobody does care. And right now in Washington, D.C., we have seen a fall of the Republic.
Get your copy of Fall of the Republic on DVD at Infowars.com or watch it online right now in super high quality at PrisonPlanet.tv.
The globalists are following a blueprint. They're following a program of control. And everything Pastor's ever called in with is checked out to be accurate. He broke here on this network. Then other pastors came forward. And he even got a FEMA Homeland Security visit. They figured out who'd sent me the documents. While the public was busy saying they were fake documents that had actual FEMA phone numbers about teacher flocks to turn their guns in when told, to go to the FEMA center to take the shots. It's of the Lord. And a few years later, they had different newscasts around the country with preachers saying, it's of the Lord to go to the camp. Martial law is good. Let's do what the authorities say. We're the government's problem. The American people are bad. I mean, I've played that probably 50 times here on air. And they just say it with a straight face. The government's biggest problem is you. See, you're not the government now. You're the enemy. You're the slave. You're the terrorist. You're the bad one. What did the Army person earlier calling in about people protesting outside their drone base in America? The police in there called them terrorists, the MPs. I've got FEMA on tape before 9/11, 2000, Kansas City. Firemen shot the video. In there with firefighters, deputies, and police. And they were bad-mouthing George Washington, Thomas Jefferson, Benjamin Franklin, saying America's bad. And people see this footage and don't think it's real. The government is run by hardcore criminals, and they go in and teach the cops all this. And if the cops wake up, good, you just get kicked out of the force or relegated to supply or something. Yeah, sure, they've had all the different surveys of the troops. Well, you shoot at Americans. And on average, it's close to 80% usually that say no. Well, you just get shot up with all the deadly vaccines and shipped overseas for 6 tours. But the guys that say they'll shoot at Americans, they're like, all right, you're an officer. Boom. And by the way, when you're out here in 4 years, we got a police department waiting for you. And a lot of these cops now, we showed you that internal memo from DPS. They said, we want military. We want military. That's who we're actually only going to hire. Total discrimination against the rest of the population. Specific military were sent by the Department of Defense. Department of Defense is like, here's somebody who'll do whatever they're told. They'll take every shot we give them. They'll confiscate every gun we tell them to take. They're like, all right, they're going in a DPS trooper uniform. They're fast-tracked. They're in. It's over. And they're just forging this army of miscreants against us who will do whatever they are told. The last number we got a few years ago was 100,000 preachers, and it grows exponentially. It doubles every year, and we got that 3 years ago, I guess, 2.5, 3 years ago. So it had started with 10,000, then 20,000, then 40,000, then 80,000. So it's more than 100,000 preachers in America. And then now you see the actual propaganda in the sermons and on TV. Romans 13, do what government says. Hard times are coming. This was all being done before the implosion of the economy. All premeditated. That is right out of the Soviet Union. The preachers trained and the manuals go to the camp. I mean, this is total evidence of the government getting ready during emergencies to have your pastor come in and say, just like in Red Dawn, you know, a fictitious example of the Soviets taking over part of the U.S., and who do they have? They have the preacher, they have the mayor, all, you know, cowards, the politicians there to keep the city in line. And they come to the mayor and they say, we want you to give us names of the families and kids. We're going to kill them. The mayor goes, isn't that a little harsh? And they said, listen, you're only in the position you are because we want you there. Do you want to be arrested? And he's like, no, I'll report on all the children too. Good. That's who they are. They love feds coming in. Now you tell them to go to the camp when we say. They're like, yes, sir, I will. Instead of completely freaking out at secret police coming in, we want you to watch your flock and report on them. But it's all done in a friendly, for the security of America, we got hit by Al-Qaeda. That's always at first, and later it's like, it's these Ron Paul groups, we want you to target them. When the time comes, you tell them it's of the Lord to take the shots. It's of the Lord to go to the camp. It's of the Lord to turn their guns in. And those preachers actually get off on it. They're like, yes. And their seminaries order them. All these big centralized World Council of Churches, Rockefeller system, they all tell them what to do. And if their preacher won't do it, I know a lot of preachers are forced into retirement, then they send in the next ones. They send them in. They send in these weird husband and wife teams and the rest of it. And they come in and it's Bill and Melinda Gates is here. Take the shots. It's of the Lord. Ooh, it's so lordly. Right here in Austin. Government operatives coiled up like big fat cobras just sitting up there at the front of the church. I mean, you talk about a wicked government. And of course, this all went on under Bush, so folks are like, it's of the Lord, faith-based initiative. And as soon as the churches go along with the evil, they get the free trucks, they get the free TVs, they get the money. All right, now, I got to get to other news and your calls, but Pastor was bringing up some of these high-level folks he was talking to, and they were saying the way they're going to get the global government is through technology deals. Well, that's always public. See, a lot of these feds think they've got something that's secret. Just because the general public doesn't know how to tie their shoes and doesn't know which end is up doesn't mean all the stuff you think so secret isn't actually public in white papers. And in any organic intelligence operation, the movements and the systems of the globalists reveal what's happening beneath the surface as well. And because the globalists know we're so dumbed down, they operate in full view with just simple label changes on what they're doing. So their entire op is completely transparent and nightmarish. They don't even care I get on air and talk about uranium being added to the water supplies. Then they just come out and respond because local newscasters hear it. Notice this all broke in Texas because I was pointing out some cases in Texas. And then they go out and test the pipes and they're highly radioactive and the government comes in and says, it's in the aquifer. And the local news goes, all right, it's in the aquifer. Then we've got to say, no, test the aquifer water. It's not the aquifer. It's being added in the sodium fluoride now. There's local newscasts going, the feds told us that it was in the aquifer, but it wasn't. We're trying to find out where it come from. Because their bosses at the news stations won't let them say it's the government. Oh, Mr. Jones or Mr. Johnson or Mr. Brown or Mrs. Brown, that's too inflammatory to say it's the sodium fluoride. Well, boss, I'm trying to get into the water treatment plant. I'm trying to get in right now, but they're not letting me get in. Reportedly, I can get samples from what they're adding. Reportedly, it's on the bag. We don't want to cause trouble with the city here now. Don't report that. We're going to keep feeding our kids uranium. We do. We told. The preacher said it's Romans 13. Ah! Do you hear what I'm talking about? Do you hear the incredible bombshell nature of it? Every morning I wake up like out of a dream. Oh, everything's all right. Oh, my gosh, it's all real. Every day it hits me just how hardcore it is, just how incredible it is, just how evil it is, how amazing it is. Up until 3 years ago, in every manual in every country, they said never give a pregnant woman a vaccine. It causes brain damage or miscarriage. Now they say in TV ads, vaccinate more when you're pregnant. And the women's babies die, and it's all a test to see if they can kill your baby and then handle it and how to finagle it through the news media because they want to start killing more and more people now and just get it kind of normal. Oh, breast cancer. I actually looked up the numbers yesterday. Breast cancer has tripled since 1981. CDC's own numbers. I covered that last night on the news. Tripled. And they say it's set to triple again. And I know it feels too good to believe in the system and it's too scary. So you're not going to believe me, new listeners. I understand. You're going to sit there and bury your daughter, bury your mother, bury your wife. Oh, isn't it fun to watch your wife getting chopped up and burned and watching their beautiful breasts get removed and all of this hell and then watching them shrivel up and sticking them in the ground? It's too much fun to buy into the evil. It's too much fun to love it. It's too much fun to get into it. It's just you love it. 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 And you will continue to love it. I'm talking to you out there who won't listen to me. I want it to stop now. Now, and the only way it's going to stop is waking up to the full horror of what we got going here. But it's not, we're not going to turn this around, ladies and gentlemen, until you grow up. I told you each time they have a bailout, it's going to get worse. I told you they'd announce a Bank of the World run by private banks. It's all been announced. They're announcing it as a political dictatorship run by banks in Europe. We're already under it with the Super Congress. And the sick thing is 99.999. Jaron, do the number out of 7 billion people. Divide 6,000 into 7 billion, please. The globalists say there's 6 billion superclass minions, less than 20 families. Rothkopf, best-selling Washington Post articles about it, everything. Superclass. We've had him on. Head of the Kissinger Group. He thought I was Alex S. Jones of the Shorenstein Center, who also does commentary on NPR. He figured out it was. That has been very useful. These guys, a lot of times that happens. They figure out it's not Alex S. Jones. We don't tell them I'm Alex S. Jones. But they just, oh, Alex S. Jones is called. Certainly I'll. Because, see, normally nobody wants to interview CFR heads and, you know, groups like that. No one's really calling them except for national news. That's not on the radar for talk radio because Rush Limbaugh used to say it didn't exist. I heard him 20 years ago say the CFR didn't exist. Didn't exist. Didn't exist. And so you call these guys up and you automatically think, oh, it's another one of them. Because nobody wants to interview them but their own people. How many times does 6,000 divide into 7 billion? Well, we'll get that going here. Let's go ahead and go back to Pastor in Ohio, and I got to get to the other callers because we got Peter Schiff coming up and Kurt Haskell. Heaven help us. Go ahead, Pastor. Finish your point.
Okay, you mentioned the cancer, how it's increasing. One of the, like I said, they're going to offer, what it said is they're going to offer new technology to prolong people's life.
Yeah, they give you the bioweapon. They then give you the treatment, but it sterilizes you.
Right. But it still, it offers longer life. They've been playing with this all along because with government assistance and everything else just to see how people will follow. Now, here's the thing. Churches are to are actually pushing people away. Instead of helping them, they're pushing people away towards the government.
Yes.
Because they can't afford it. They need to spend their money on all this high technology and pastor salaries and all these other things and programs. Everybody's pushing programs, so they got to have the money to do that. And big monster churches and everything else.
Yeah, anything but the Bible.
Right. Now, that's one of the things they mentioned. But here's the thing. These people that are in these white hats that are in these places, they're all over the world. And, I mean, they've even mentioned, you know, certain things about the earthquake in Virginia and the one out in California weren't actually earthquakes. Or Colorado and Virginia. Those weren't actually earthquakes. But then that's something that needs to be checked out. Because of the way the seismographs.
No, I understand. It just came up from nowhere with no buildup. I got to jump. I appreciate your call. It's always good to hear from you. Okay, so the globalists themselves say there's 6,000 operatives. Less than 20 is about 18 families total. And there's only a few at the top of that. So we're talking about 6,000 people divided into 7 billion. And 6,000 divides into 7 billion. 1,166,666.67 times. That's weird to get all those sixes there. But there you have it. So it divides in. So we outnumber them millions to one. But we've got to let them kill us because they're wearing fancy suits and talk to us like we're children with authority. This is the way it is. Get over there and do that. Do what I say. Take the shots. Eat the GMO. Just see them for who they are. Learn that they're murderers, understand they're your mortal enemy, and then begin to wake people up to the enemy, and we will bring them down, period. All right, I'm going to go to all these other callers here. I've got all this other news I need to hit on the economy. We're watching that stock market 400 points down. And then again, they're saying banker dictatorship will fix everything. I also just want to add again, we are doing some power pack transmissions where I don't just rant and rave the whole time, but actually get into all the meat and potatoes. I'm very proud of the show we did last night. It's an hour long, getting into eugenics, their master plan, the vaccines. Such an important one-hour transmission with Dr. Wakefield. And the expanded extra 10 minutes or so, or I guess 15-minute interview I did with them, because we ran out of time and couldn't air it last night, that's going to be posted at prisonplanet.tv coming up in the next few hours. But also the entire last night's show and the stuff that hadn't been seen yet will be sent out to the InfoWars insiders. And all you do is go to InfoWars.com and sign up for the free email there at the top, and then we will send that out to you if you want to see it exclusively there. You don't have to be a prisonplanet.tv member from time to time. Well, every Wednesday we'll send out the Tuesday night show via email. But a lot of times these reports are so important, we'll send it out to everybody. And then I want you to forward the email to everyone you know. Also, I want to tell you about eFoodsDirect.com. I promote what I believe in. And everybody needs high-quality, storable foods. This is all grown right here in America, except for the bananas. It's non-GMO, non-hybrid. Super high-quality, storable food. Free shipping to anywhere in the United States on all their products for a limited time. They only do this about every 8-9 months they do this. So a little more than once a year. I guess about every, I don't know. The point is that it's a special. It's running for a limited time. 800-409-5633, 800-409-5633. There's a lot of storable foods companies out there, but this is one that has fresh, you know, recently produced food, not 10-year-old stuff. We're talking made every week. eFoodsDirect.com/Alex. to find these specials. eFoodsDirect.com/Alex or 800-409-5633. Also, please don't let them murder your little ones with the radioactive isotopes and the sodium fluoride. Go to purewaterfreedom.com today for whole house, tabletops, reverse osmosis, bottle, handheld units, all at purewaterfreedom.com, 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 and they're made in America. You know, I really had an epiphany yesterday. The Soviets, Pol Pot, fascists, they always come into an area and kill all the intelligentsia. You can read, you can write, you're wearing glasses, they see you as wealthy, they kill you. And the U.S. government actually funded Pol Pot to do that because the rural people were seen as okay, but some of the intelligentsia were communists, so they were all killed. It's all vice versa, whatever group the globalists want to kill at that time. Here, they just kill you with chemical weapons in the water. They kill your intellect. They just kind of turn you into an addled zombie that stumbles around. So I go to purewaterfreedom.com and at least try to mitigate how many chemical weapons they're hitting you with. We're going to go ahead and go to break. I want to tell you about Survival RX. Legislation like Codex Alimentarius threatens our ability to purchase vitamins and supplements in the future. Our new sponsor, Survival RX, is the world's first long-term storable vitamins and nutritional supplements. They've been a long-term company, but now they're making this. They created a proprietary triple nitrogen flush manufacturing process that will allow you to store high-quality vitamins for decades. Survival RX has extended their free shipping special. So folks, check them out today. Go to survivalrx.com today. That's survivalrx.com. Just survival, the word survival, with rx.com for long-term storable vitamins. It's absolutely vital to have those. Great idea. I've ordered some myself. Survivalrx.com. We'll be back. Stay with us.
If you're a man over 40, you may feel like half the man you used to be. Are you gaining more body fat? Are you feeling tired? Are you losing your sex drive? It's not your fault. After 40, your body's testosterone may start dropping. And if you are an African-American man, you're at a higher risk of your testosterone turning into estrogen. Be the man you used to be. Call for a risk-free trial of Ageless Male, a natural supplement shown to raise testosterone by 61% and maintain healthy, normal levels. You can feel the youthful energy and the healthy sex drive you once had. And Ageless Male is all natural. No injections or appointments. Just one quick phone call. Get your risk-free trial of Ageless Male.
Call 1-800-497-8345. That's 1-800-497-8345. With Ageless Male, you can raise your testosterone naturally by 61%. Call 1-800-497-8345. That's 1-800-497-8345.
Infowars.com for 16 years has led the charge against the technocrats. We have had unrivaled success in unlocking minds, expanding paradigms, and rallying the people to face the new world order. No one can deny that our media operation is the tip of the spear, and it's because of our success that we have a responsibility to intensify our operations against the globalist 110%. We're only a month away from launching a weeknight news broadcast. The social network is nearing completion as well. The free newsletter is reaching hundreds of thousands. Please spread the word about Infowars.com and PrisonPlanet.com. Sign up at the top of Infowars.com for the free Infowars Insider email with exclusive video and text reports as well as breaking news. Look in the mirror. You are the resistance. It is up to us, the Info Warriors, to take the initiative and to defeat the globalist. Our rights as individuals to freely purchase dietary supplements over the counter are under constant attack. The globalists want to ban all supplements formulated after 1994. Governments are hoarding raw materials, affecting our ability to purchase these products at a reasonable price. Even organic foods are stripped of nutrients due to overuse of soil and compromised growing conditions. Storable foods are essential, but you also need to make sure you have the nutrients you need to stay healthy during emergencies. Go to survivalrx.com today and see the amazing line of storable supplements they have to protect the ones you love. The owners of SurvivalRx.com have been in sports nutrition for over a decade, and they realize the need for long-term storable vitamins. The result is a triple nitrogen flushing method, which allows these vitamins to maintain their strength for decades. Again, go to SurvivalRx.com. That's SurvivalRx.com.
All right, we got Kurt Haskell. survivor of the wicked underwear bomber on Christmas Day, coming up with some big developments. He's been at the pre-trial stuff. Some breaking news coming up. Continue with your calls. Peter Schiff popping in to look at the global meltdown of the economy that we're watching here. All according to plan. QE3, here it goes. Let's talk to David in Michigan. David, thanks for holding her on the air.
Yes, hello, Alex. Good day.
Welcome, sir. Thank you for holding.
Yes, well, it's been a little while. I sort of started out knowing what I was going to talk to you about, but listening to all this stuff just kind of scrambled my brain, but I do have a few things. Pat on the back to you and your entire crew, and a hoorah for Ron Paul. And one thing, I would love to have had on the 11th. I'm, like I say, too so scrambled right now. I'm just going to put out a couple information things. I'd love to buy your T-shirt, but I want it to come as a combination with a flag. Think about that. If you want to see if listeners want to do it, put it out there, cool. But I would love to do that. I'd love to have the same flag flying next to my little yellow one. It's been flying since 1964.
What do you want, an InfoWars flag or a Liberty or Death flag?
Liberty or Death flag, just like the T-shirt, InfoWars, prison planted around the border.
You know what? I've been wanting to do a flag for a while. You want it, you got it. We're not going to come out with one flag. We're going to come out with three flags. How's that sound?
Well, sounds great to me, buddy. Hey, but I'd love to fly it right next to my other one. It's been flying since my mother took on the city of Plymouth, Michigan here in 1964. It'd be great to have next to it, wouldn't it?
Good job. Yeah, that's a great way to advertise Liberty, too.
Absolutely, and it tells who you are without, you know, just throwing it in their face.
Now, let's go back to what you originally called. Just think back to the issue you wanted to call in about. What do you think of the drones? I was saying they now admit the drones are going to be robot-controlled, no human decision, pre-programmed, and that's where they've always wanted to go with this, where the globalists have a robot army working for them.
Well, that whole it doesn't surprise me. We always kind of saw it if you were into sci-fi and had really thought about it, you would actually know that this is possible. And, well, I was in Fort Bliss, and I learned a lot of things. And one thing I did learn, a bit one reason I was calling, is when it finally had come out that we're doing the weapons and the drugs and stuff through there, basically, I just kind of laughed, and people couldn't understand why. I says, people have known this forever, but you couldn't say it.
Well, that's right. I've had a lot of family who are Army officers, and it's just well known.
Mm-hmm. It was totally amazing. So, yes, the flag deal is very big for me. And one thing, radio stations, is there anywhere on Prison Planet or InfoWars that we can find all the stations? Detroit metro area? I haven't found one. Maybe it's just me.
No, we're not on in Detroit. There's a list at gcnlive.com, my friend. Great points. Thank you so much for the call. Let's jam in another call. I'm going to do that. You want it, you got it. Here come the flags. Let's go ahead and take another call here, and let's talk to Tim in Washington. Thanks for holding.
Yeah, how's it going, Alex?
Good.
Yeah, I was wondering if you know anything about Operation Mountain Guardian.
It rings a little bell. Tell me about Mountain Guardian.
It's a terrorist drill that's going on in Denver on tomorrow, Friday, September 23rd, and it's involving 81 different agencies. And it also coincides with Operation Cock Pistol, which is going on the 27th, which I guess is a DEFCON 1 terrorist drill with Obama at Denver. And it also coincides with the common alignment as well.
Yeah, here it is, a business journal, Operation Mountain Guardian, a terrorism-based full-scale emergency exercise, happens Friday at four primary locations, including Union Station. Wow, I ought to send reporters to that. I wish I'd have known about that. They're having these all the time, but if Obama's involved, that means it's a national-level exercise. They like to run them in Denver because that's where Northcom's really based, as you know. Anything else, sir?
Well, yeah, it's just that there's like six or seven different things going on in Denver all at the same time, around the time that they're...
We need listeners to shoot video of it.
You are listening to GCN. Visit GCNlive.com today.
Hi, folks. This is Alex Jones. I'm looking for people that have the wisdom to spot savings, opportunity, and recognize risk. Saving means to make money. The Calbin Pure Soap Company can save you thousands of dollars and give you good old-fashioned real soaps. that are triple concentrated and twice as good as what you're using now. Soaps made from vegetable and coconut oils that contain no useless dyes, perfumes, deodorants, or antibacterials. Your risk is the hundreds of hazardous toxic detergents that give you rashes, itching sores, and deteriorating clothing called lint. If you want something better, if you want something you've never had before, you have to do something you've never done before. Getting a free catalog is easy by calling 800-340-7091 or see Calvin on the web at 5starsoap.com. Take charge of your health now by calling 800-340-7091 or see Calvin on the web at 5starsoap.com.
Waging war on corruption. Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. Big Brother. Mainstream media. Government cover-ups. You want answers? Well, so does he. He's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. And now, live from Austin, Texas, Alex Jones.
All right, folks, we're back in the third hour. A listener just alerted me to a national-level exercise. They're going to be blowing stuff up and terrorizing the city. Here's the Denver Post. Relax, it's just a drill, a loud, scary drill. I sent Rob Dew and others to a drill last year in Illinois where they practiced putting citizens in a FEMA camp. I'm tempted to send some of our InfoWars Nightly News reporters to this. Don't panic Friday if your surroundings erupt with sounds and images more familiar with Kandahar than Denver. More than 100 emergency agencies will take part in a terrorism response exercise that promises to attract attention throughout the metro area. Simulated explosions will boom, smoke will rise, emergency vehicles will blare warning signals as fake weapons are drawn. Oh, man, I got to... Okay. The exercise Operation Mountain Guardian is scheduled to begin at 5 a.m. and end at 4:30 p.m., and will involve 14 separate locations. The exercise is an opportunity for regional first responders to react to mock terror-driven catastrophe. Now, the issue here is they use these for federal martial law takeover drills, and a lot of times in the case of 7-7, 9-11, they use a drill to actually stage an attack. They go, oh, what a funny coincidence. And then that way, if any of their operatives get caught staging the attack, they just say, oh, it was part of a drill. Now, shifting gears for the next 30 minutes, and then we're going to have Peter Schiff joining us, is Kurt Haskell. Government entrapment underwear bomber case, Kurt Haskell reports. We had him on the Nightly News a few nights ago. Here's another one. Kurt Haskell blows the whistle on underwear bomber given bomb by U.S. government to boost TSA budget and implement body scanners. That's We Are Change InfoWars reporting on what he said. Flight 253 passenger Kurt Haskell, I was visited by the FBI. This is back from December of 09. Everything he talked about has come true, what he and his wife saw, and now he is saying inside job. Kurt, we're going to a break in a moment, but recap and give us the latest developments. You've been going to the beginning of the trial, and even the standby lawyer, you said their case, if they could take it, would be entrapment.
Right. You know, as I've been saying, I've been going to the hearings because I found out that the mainstream media isn't really reporting what's going on at the hearings, not in my opinion. So I've been going down witnessing them. And, you know, it's quite apparent that the prosecution's hiding evidence from the defense. And, you know, you'd have to ask, why are they doing that? Number one, if we have some crazy lunatic Al-Qaeda guy, you know, with 200 some odd witnesses here that saw him try to blow up a plane, why do we have to hide evidence? So, you know, that's a big question that people need to think about. And, you know, as I talked about on your show a couple days ago, the evidence that was recently turned over to Chambers ties in with exactly what I've been saying all along. They withheld this evidence for 19 months or so to not let Chambers hire experts to look at it, to testify on behalf of the defense, or to analyze it. And, you know, things like the passport, I guess it took them a while to create Umar's passport, 18, 19 months, because, you know, he didn't have it, as I've been saying all along. and things like that. I don't know. Do you want me to keep going, Alex? Do you have a break?
Yeah, this is just incredible. Yeah, we're going to break in a moment. I want you to come back and recap all this. But sure. Just like they planted passports on 9/11, and then it turned out it was the wrong guy they planted it on, so they withdrew those. Just like they found one at the Flight 93 site. You witnessed him being gotten on the plane without the passport. Later, the State Department had to admit, and we got that clip coming up in Congress, that an unnamed agency ordered them to give him the visa. And so you've got them. And it just really shows you just how criminal the prosecutors are as well. They're all complicit, and I guess they love it.
Yeah, you know, it's really obvious to me that prosecutors are in on this. Just, you can just tell with what they say at the hearings and their attitude. And, they know they have an open and shut case, but not for the reasons you think. They have an open and shut case because they know he doesn't have an attorney. He only has a standby attorney.
Stay there. Let's recap it all. On the other side, Kurt Haskell with incredible information that could bring these criminals down if we use it.
This is Alex Jones with five good reasons you should consider buying a solar power generator. Number one, new climate legislation could easily double or triple your electric bill. Number two, our new energy czar wants to control how much power your electric company allows you to have. It's true. Total government control of electricity in the name of smart grid technology is coming. Number three, in some areas of the country, the power grid is dangerously overloaded. And now new socialist legislation is only compounding the problem. Number four, dangerous weather is always a threat to local grids. Every year, thousands of families lose their power from weather-related outages. Number five, a solar power generator provides powerful backup insurance and peace of mind. Folks, I really believe in the solar power generators offered by Solutions from Science, one of my oldest sponsors. You can get more information at www.mysolarbackup.com. That's mysolarbackup.com. Remember, the government doesn't own the sun, so go to mysolarbackup.com or call 1-877-327-0365.
When you're out on the road, the last place you want to be is on the road. But if the unfortunate happens, you'll be glad you were wearing diamond gussets.
There's a place down in Tennessee where they make blue diamond gusset jeans. They sew pride in every stitch. Guarantee you love the way they fit. They put a diamond gusset in the crotch where you need it most. Blue diamond gussets got it. Others don't.
We turn jeans inside out. Diamond gusset jeans. Made in the USA with unparalleled quality. Our Defender motorcycle jeans combine gusset comfort with Kevlar protection, so you can ride all day with confidence. Order yours at gusset.com. Diamond gusset jeans got it. Others don't.
You may be arrested and or subject to other police action.
Tyranny is here. The grim future foretold in 1984 has become reality.
It really says that the state is God.
The United States is now recognized globally as one of the most oppressive police states on Earth. This film conclusively proves the existence of a secret network of FEMA camps, now being expanded nationwide. This documentary exposes how the continuity of government program has established an all-powerful shadow state. Police State 4 chronicles the sickening depths to which our republic has fallen. Prepare to enter the secretive world of emergency dictatorship. Body scanners, sound cameras, citizen spies, stage terror, and cameras on every street corner. It's only the beginning of the New World Order's hellish plan. The police state isn't coming. It's here. Secure your copy today at Infowars.com or see it online in the highest quality at PrisonPlanet.tv.
Big Brother, mainstream media, government cover-ups. You want answers? Well, so does he. He's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. And now, live from Austin, Texas, Alex Jones.
Okay, Kurt Haskell is our guest. He and his wife are both attorneys. He survived the underwear bombing attack from the flight from Amsterdam to Detroit, Michigan on Christmas Day back in 2009. And Kurt, recap for listeners that just tuned in, the latest developments, the inconsistencies, and now as a survivor, the fact that you are clearly saying that this is an inside job in your researched view.
Right. Well, Alex, I think the evidence is now overwhelming that this is definitely a false flag set up by the U.S. government. Just anyone that does their research, I think, will come to the same conclusion. Obviously, this being part of my life, I've done thousands of hours of research into this. So, you know, I think you have to take a look at who can control the not only the media, but the courts, the prosecutors, what witnesses say or don't say, who can control what law enforcement says and what the victim says. And there's only one entity that can do that, in my opinion, the U.S. government. That's what we have here. And it's becoming increasingly obvious. If you go back to a hearing I went to on July 7, 2011, this was a hearing set up by standby attorney Chambers. Remember, Chambers, Umar does not have an attorney. He's representing himself, but Chambers is the helper of sorts. Anyway, he set this hearing up because he wanted to delay the trial that's set to start here October 4th. And the reasons he gave, and I was sitting in the courtroom watching this, and this wasn't reported this way in the media, but he said, I just received the most significant evidence of the case. The most significant. Remember what my theory is. The U.S. government gave Umar an intentionally defective bomb, escorted him without a passport through security to stage this attack. Well, that's my theory. Here's what he says he got. A copy of Umar's passport. Okay. Why has this been withheld for 18 months? Did it take them that long to create it? I mean, come on. Don't you just make a copy and hand it over within a couple weeks? Okay, number one. Number two, a discontinuing chemical analysis of the composition of the bomb. Perhaps, maybe, the composition shows that it couldn't have exploded, as all the experts that have been hired so far have indicated, to Chambers anyway, and he's told that to me. Airport security video and audio. Okay, why was this withheld for 18, 19 months when it can clearly show what I've been saying all along? By the way, all of this is still under a protective order, so nobody can talk about it. No one can talk about the details of it. Judge Edmonds issued this early in January 10. I want to talk about that in a few minutes, but nobody can talk about the content of this. This is why we're not seeing it in the media. Four disks of DNA analysis. I'm not really sure what that is, but okay. And the next thing that was turned over, a witness statement from a Dutch non-law enforcement citizen government profiler who talked to Umar during the time in question. And after thinking about this for a while, I think this would be the sharp-dressed man. And I think the sharp-dressed man is the person that asked these security questions in Amsterdam. They have an additional level of security there that we don't have here in the U.S. They have a security interview. And after looking at this, hearing Chambers talk, thinking about it, I'm thinking that this was the sharp-dressed man. So the next question is, why is his witness statement being withheld for 18 months or 19 months from Chambers? Why was this statement so important or, for whatever reason, withheld this long? Again, it's to give Chambers the least amount of time and least amount of resources to look into these things to prepare a good case.
Now, Kurt, just briefly, for people that don't know the backside on this, and we have the clip from C-SPAN. If we have time, we'll play it. But the Detroit Free Press reported on it as well. The Undersecretary of State, Mr. Kennedy, testified on C-SPAN a month and a half after you made your claims along with your wife, and since then others saw similar things, that the clearly disheveled, you know, could have been drugged, out of it, Mutallab, not wearing a coat in freezing weather, is led on by the sharp-dressed man. There's a little bit of an argument with security, but this guy's so high up, he's able to get him on without the passport. You witness all this. They admitted there wasn't a passport. Now suddenly it's appeared. I mean, this gets weirder and weirder and weirder. So we know they got him on the plane. Please continue.
Yeah, you know, the testimony by Patrick Kennedy, if you just watch the video of it on the internet, you see him squirming in his chair to lie and not say that this was an intentional plot. It's so obvious to anyone that watches it. So you have, and then after that, what's also telling is nobody reported that there were hearings in Congress over this. If you look on the internet, the mainstream media, I think maybe the Detroit News and maybe one other newspaper even had an article about these hearings. You think these would be significant? Nobody talked about them because they were such, they were so telling that this was an obvious setup. And, you know, from then on, you have the government saying, oh, yeah, we need to do this because of the underwear bomber case or that, this or that. They all refer to this case as a basis to do whatever they want for spending and to cut down on our rights. So it's so telling. And if the people would just see, hey, this is a setup here, then everyone would be questioning, well, why do we have body scanners in the airports? Now, why are we spending all this on TSA? Why are they now going to NFL stadiums or whatever? It's just totally ridiculous, in my opinion, and it's so obvious. You know, something I really haven't talked about yet, and I've shied away from this somewhat, is a discussion about Judge Edmonds. You know, I watched her in the courtroom quite a few times, and she doesn't seem to be biased if you watch her in the courtroom, but the more I think about her rulings, the more I have an issue with her. We'll just say that, because it's Judge Edmonds that put in this protective order that indicates that nobody can talk about the evidence at all. So you have, you know, you have the airport video, chemical analysis of the bomb, and all these other things that could be talked about, but instead, no one can talk about these things that would show that this was an intentional setup. It's all hush-hush. Of course, now Umar's representing himself. Is that any of this even going to come out? Probably not. Case closed. Let's move on. But not only that, a couple other rulings Judge Edmonds did, you know, were along the same line. One was that since Chambers is only a standby attorney, he can only have the evidence that Umar decides to give him. So Umar gets all the evidence. Chambers can only see what Umar wants to give him. And then the second part of the July 7th hearing, which I didn't get to, was after Chambers complained that, hey, I was given all these things last minute, he then said, well, what have I not been given? Is there other evidence being withheld? You know, how can I be sure I have everything? And instead of the prosecution saying, yes, you have everything now, they said, well, there is more evidence we're withholding. It's secret government evidence, and we're not going to turn it over. We're going to let you look at it, Judge Edmonds. And
so we're getting national security declared here, just like in Chicago last month. It's now been confirmed Sinaloa drug cartel did ship in massive tonnage of cocaine under U.S. government contract and guns into Mexico. I mean, this is just amazing how they declare this national security.
Right. And again, what is the official story? A crazy Al-Qaeda man goes through and lights off this bomb. Okay, where's the national security there? We have, again, 200 some eyewitnesses. We can easily go in and say, yeah, he lit this bomb. He should go to prison the rest of his life. Case closed. Where's the national security here? But again, that ties into another aspect of this. There's just so many offshoots to this.
Well, they find mentally ill people in all the big patsy cases and provocateur them to do these events, or they frame somebody and then threaten to kill their family, as we know happened with McVeigh.
So in this, you know, something else that's kind of interesting here, it took the prosecution a year to charge Umar with conspiracy. Now, this was only after all plea negotiations had broken down, do they bring out this charge. Obviously, they didn't want to make this charge because the next question is, and again, you don't see anyone talking about the conspiracy charge. It's not being reported anywhere. The news isn't talking about it. Why not? And the bigger question is, who are the co-conspirators? Why aren't they being charged? Why aren't they on the FBI's 10 most wanted list? Why isn't their participation being described? The evidence that there's conspiracy, where is it? And it all ties back to the same thing. The co-conspirators are undercover government agents. It's too obvious, Alex. It just all ties
well,
in
Kurt,
together.
That's the MO that we've seen over and over and over and over again. Even mainstream news the last 2 years admits where the FBI goes and creates out of whole cloth and finds mentally ill, welfare, ex-prisoner type to do this. I mean, they've been caught over and over again, not infiltrating groups, but purely creating them.
Right, right. It seems like they're their activities have no ends here, because they control everything. They control the release of the information, what activities take place. They control the courts, the media. It's all a perfect setup. They have free rein to do anything they want, and it continues and it continues and still continues. You know, if this were a legitimate situation, we would have Umar with a legitimate attorney presenting a case, presenting all the evidence accurately, calling people as witnesses like myself to testify in an entrapment case. We don't have that here. We're not going to see it, in my opinion. We're going to see Umar go and make some show that where all the media can report on him being a crazy nut job, and they can put pictures of it on TV and acting crazy and say, hey, this is a crazy terrorist. But the real story won't come out. It's being covered up, and I think it will always be covered up. At least that's the sense I'm getting now. And
well, Kurt, I mean, look, day one, it's Sunday, or it's Christmas Day. Felt like a Sunday. It's Christmas Day, and I'm driving up to get eggs. And within the time I went in, you know, driving up, I hear that there's been an underwear bombing on a flight into Detroit on Christmas Day. And then by the time I got out of the store 5 minutes later, they were already saying, don't worry, we've got body scanners that just so happen to be going in next month. We've just made the order for them. But I knew from covering it that they just made the order, a year before, and that Chertoff was involved. I mean, this whole thing was a rollout, and the fear-mongering and the wringing of the hands and the little bomb and then the connections to it and the way they handled it. And then you came out on your blog and said he was gotten on the airplane. And the government's like, that's preposterous. And then a month and a half later, it comes out in congressional testimony that indeed that's true. And then there's no subsequent investigation. How much more obvious does this have to get?
I agree. You know, and all the people that came out and said, hey, I'm doing this for money, publicity, political office, promote my law office, whatever. Well, I think I've shut them all up now. They've all seemed to have gone away. I don't have any agenda here. I never have, just getting out this story. And, I have to question, too, some of the passengers. Where are the passengers in backing me up on this story? You know, I've been told that many of them were military personnel, government employees, and government contractors, and, you know, there were some foreign citizens. Hardly any U.S. citizens with no ties to the military or the government. I don't really know how I even got on this plane. But don't you think they should be out there backing me up on this story, at least some of them? I mean, where are they? Even some that I try and contact ignore me. Now, I've talked to some. But, you know, interestingly enough, Alex, by the way, I think they should be out there supporting me, or at least doing investigative work to see if I'm right or not, but we don't have that. But something you might be interested in, I actually got a call from the cameraman in this story. There's been much talk about the man that pulled out his video camera and filmed this whole story. And since I talked to you, I talked to you a couple days ago, but I didn't mention this. He called me out of the blue about 2 months ago, and we talked about an interview he was going to do with prosecutors and some security, and I believe FBI or CIA or something. And we talked about it, and he told me that he was filming outside at 20,000 feet and turned his camera and started filming the incident. Then it didn't stop. Now that's his story. For what it's worth, the story doesn't sound real credible, but just for what it's worth, he did sound credible to me. And I, at least at this point, I think his involvement is probably a red herring in this to detract from what the real story is, the sharp dressed man and the other man arrested, the man in orange. But anyway, it was just kind of interesting to me that he called me out of the blue to talk.
Now, do we know whatever happened to the other guy that was arrested that the government tries to deny was arrested?
No, we don't know. We don't know about him. Again, you know, the government changed their story on him 5 times, continually lied.
Did you see the report 2 weeks ago with the supposed live explosives smuggled into the Phoenix airport by the police in a drill and then lost and then dumped on the side of the road?
No, I'm not aware of that. No.
Now, there's more and more of these events, and Obama advisors, even in the Financial Times of London, have said, barring a new Oklahoma City or 9/11, they're not going to be able to get their agenda through, and you can see all the pre-hyping and fear-mongering. Kurt, you know, you survived this, your wife survived this. We've never talked to your wife, What's her views on this? Do they mirror yours?
Yeah, they do. She, just a couple of things. She didn't see the sharp-dressed man because, if you recall, we were playing cards and she was sitting opposite, so facing me, so that this happened behind her. So she isn't wanted by the media as I am because of that. And number two, she's not real comfortable with the media because early on there were some people that came out and put some negative blog postings about her, and she kind of got turned off.
Yeah, that's right. COINTELPRO trying to shut you up. The terrorists don't want you to get the word up.
Me 100% and fully supports everything I'm doing, which is good because, you know, there's some trying times with this and people saying I'm doing this for the wrong reason, but she agrees with me.
Well, Kurt, why even respond to that? You were the voice in the wilderness talking about the guy getting him on, and then later the State Department in testimony had to admit that indeed they'd been ordered to help him get on. I mean, that is incredible information, absolutely verifying what you've said. They always attack, even if it's asinine, to make you go on the defensive instead of looking at the facts. It's a way to change the subject, as you know, as a lawyer. Now, in the time we've got left here, you said on the TV show, InfoWars Nightly News, a few nights ago, that, you know, it's over, you can't fix it, leave the country. And I made the point that there's nowhere to run. This is a global corporate government. They're imploding every system. We've got to stand and fight. Now, I'm not saying you're wrong completely, and I understand your view, but, I mean, do you get my point that it's always darkest before the dawn, and yes, the government's very corrupt, but we don't have a hope. I mean, it's not like this is Albania or something, and we could just leave. America is the heart of the world government right now, and they want to take over the whole planet, these criminals, using America. We don't have a choice. We've got to stay here and expose them, and God put us in the heart of this wicked empire to be able to try to restore the republic. That's why we're here. That's why you were on that aircraft, Kurt.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, you know, I think you have a point there, but do they control the entire world yet? I guess I don't know. I'm not convinced of that yet, but maybe you are right. But, you know, I've done everything I can, I think, to expose this. And, you know, I'm just going up against the wall. So I think, at least in my position, I've done everything I can do so far to expose this. And I think, you know, I need some more help.
Have you walked over to the prosecutor in the hall and said, how can you be part of this? You know what really happened here.
No, I've thought about doing that, but I haven't. I think it would probably cause a scene, and I wouldn't want to get into any kind of screaming match. Remember, too, I can still file a civil suit. I haven't done that yet, but that's not out of the question.
And that's how you're going to start getting the documents. You know, it was civil suits that proved McVeigh was with a bunch of other men, as eyewitnesses had said, and that the feds were running the operation. And then said that all 20-something videotapes had disappeared or been destroyed or been lost. I mean, I think that's probably what's needed next is a civil suit.
Right. I'm taking the position, at least right now, I want to watch some of the trial first. I have till Christmas Day to file a case, so I'm going to watch and see how this plays out before I decide what I'm going to do with that. But I haven't made a decision on that yet, but that could potentially shed some new light on this too. I want to see how the trial plays out. If it plays out as I think it might, just a total farce, that will, you know, that may propel me more to file a civil suit.
Well, let me say this. You've already done a lot for truth. All I'm saying is you're already deep into this. You might as well go all the cards on the table, all in, because from my research, you are in danger until you get the suit going. Once you've already got that in action, they tend to go ahead and go to the game plan of trying to beat you on that. It might just be easier to kill you, though. We know these are killers in the interim. So I want to tell you what I told many others that they have subsequently killed, like the D.C. Madam and others, and, of course, Barry Jennings and others, who was a 9/11 witness, the deputy head of emergency management in New York. You need to go public now with everything. Are you watching your back, Kurt?
Well, to the extent that I can, I am. But, you know, if somebody wants to kill me, I don't think it would be too difficult, really. I try not to think about that. I'm not overly concerned about
it. No, I got
it.
You're a real man. You're just committed to the truth. And if they kill you, that's the way it is. That's exactly how I operate.
Right. If they're going to kill me, they're going to kill me. And that's fine. They can only do it once. I'm not overly concerned about that. So,
yeah, you've got the spirit. We need, you know, if we had 10,000 more people like you who would take action, Kurt, we would kick these people's butts.
You're probably right, but it would probably take 10 million.
Well, it takes 10,000 to wake up 10 million and to march on these people in the info war. Briefly, any other points, and give us your website.
Just, you know, with everything I've said, anyone paying attention to the trial, keep my position in mind as you're seeing how this plays out, so you can see how the government system works and hiding these sort of things. Because you know what's happened now, I'm telling you. You can see the misinformation and the steps they take to deceive the American public. So it'll be pretty obvious as you watch this play out. I'm going to go to as many hearings as I can to try and report on that. Obviously, I have a busy law office. I won't be able to go there every day for 2 months straight or however long it takes. I'll go as much as I can. HaskellFamily.blogspot.com is where I post all my postings on this.
And you've got amazing info there. We're going to be checking in with you as this unfolds. Everybody should pray for you and your wife and your whole family. Mr. Haskell, thank you so much. God bless you. We'll talk to you very soon. Coming up, we're going to be talking to Peter Schiff about the economic meltdown in full swing right now. I'm Alex Jones.
We're on the march. The empire's on the run. Alex Jones and the GCN Radio Network.
Hello, friends. Alex Jones here. You all know I've worked for years with Steve Shank and eFoods Direct. I have eFoods for my own emergency food supply. You know, Steve, life is different now for all of us, isn't it?
Very different. People are using this great food to survive the present hurricane season, and we've already had $40 billion worth of damage from floods, storms, quakes, and droughts. And that's just the first 8 months of this year. Natural disasters are newsworthy, but only touch a few of us Americans. The huge issue of the Greatest Depression is on everyone's mind. The unemployment, the loss of homes, lost businesses, and skyrocketing food costs are hitting every American. So everyone needs food security.
Folks, this month you will get free shipping on every food order from eFoods Direct. That's right. Every order gets free shipping starting September 6th. Get stocked up with the best storable foods out there with eFoods Direct and be prepared for any emergency before it happens. To take advantage of this special, call 800-409-5633 or go to eFoodsDirect.com/Alex.
A very wealthy U.S. citizen is predicting that in 2011, we will witness the most important day in America in more than 50 years. He says it will change everything about our lives. The way you shop, travel, invest, educate your children, and even how you take care of your health and your own family. Now, this man has made some outrageous predictions over the years. The crazy part is, he's usually right. You see, he predicted the collapse of GM, Fannie Mae, Freddie Mac, and America's biggest mall owner, General Growth Properties. In fact, Barron's called his work a dire prophecy. Recently, he created a video, which you can watch online for free, detailing his biggest and most important prediction yet, and it's a real eye-opener. I can't stress this enough. You should at least watch this free video online today. He explains everything you need to know, including simple steps you can take to protect yourself. You can find the video at www.endofamerica3.com. That's endofamerica3.com. Watch the free video at www.endofamerica3.com. That's endofamerica3.com.
Alex Jones here with vital information concerning our nation's fragile food supply. Folks, there are some truly dangerous trends forming, and I think it's important for my listeners to do three things right away. Number one, study the past. History really does repeat itself. Number two, learn to spot the dangerous food shortage trends. Number three, take decisive action. A perfect storm is brewing, or a global food crisis. That's why I'm telling everyone to read the new book, Rising Prices, Empty Shelves. Warning signs that trigger the deadliest famines in history. Don't get caught unprepared when the crisis hits. This book is only available at risingprisesemptyshelves.com. You'll also get a free copy of Supermarket Survival, How to Cut Your Grocery Bills in Half. Again, that website is risingprisesemptyshelves.com. That's risingprisesemptyshelves.com. All right, we are back live, and of course we'll be back tonight, 7 o'clock Central, 8 o'clock Eastern, 5 o'clock Pacific, 6 o'clock Mountain, with InfoWars Nightly News. We're going to be covering the imploding economy. We also have Dr. Sherry Tenpenny on the deadly Gardasil vaccine and the move to forcibly inoculate children in California without parental consent. That's all coming up 7 o'clock tonight. We're going to send out last night's hour-long special report on eugenics. The whole nine yards, I think one of the best reports we've done the last 3 weeks of this show. free to all InfoWars insiders who sign up for the free weekly newsletter. But I'm sitting on a special issue coming up this afternoon with the entire hour-long report, not just for PrisonPlanet.tv members, but for everybody. And please pass the email on to everyone you know. If you haven't signed up for the InfoWars Insider, there's a link up at the top of InfoWars.com. Here's some of the headlines right now as we go to the head of Euro-Pacific Capital, the CEO, who's predicted so much of what's now unfortunately unfolded. I know he's not glad all his predictions have come true, Peter Schiff. But just a lot of very important news taking place. Dow plunges 400 points after they announce further quantitative easing. Global markets tumble 4%. Zolik says the world is in danger. Their answer, give the euro completely over to the private bankers. Soros says U.S. already a double dip. How about a depression? Global meltdown. Investors dumping everything. CNBC breaks that down. Also, in other economic news, we've got some very important developments on that front that we're going to be breaking down with our guests here. Here's an amazing number. Study. Immigrants filled 81% of new jobs in Texas. Well, that's the thing, is that if you pay taxes and work in the system, then you can't afford to live. But the illegals pay very low taxes, and most of their wives stay home and get welfare. That's on record, and there's studies on that. And so the government subsidizes with taxpayer money, driving down the wages. This is not free market. This is a rigged crony situation. Incredible news on that front. You've got billions and billions spent on, quote, green jobs given to select insiders. You've got Obama with the lowest approval rating ever of a president this far into the presidency. The Democrats are talking about ditching him, but that won't matter. They'll just put in some new puppet. It'll take folks a while to figure out that the new puppet isn't going to save them. Same thing with Rick Perry on the Republican side of things, along with Mitt Romney. Obamacare lovers, Hillary care lovers, carbon tax lovers, former chief of staff for Al Gore in the case of Texas with Rick Perry. I mean, you can't make this up. It's only Ron Paul. We are deep into this. But going to Peter Schiff, the CEO of Euro-Pacific Capital, joining us via video connection from his headquarters. Wow, we are really seeing things plunge. What is happening in your analysis right now?
Yeah, you know, first of all, Alex, the bad news is all of my predictions have not come true. I think a lot more of them are going to, which means it's going to get a lot worse. You know, this phony economy is unraveling, which is actually a good thing. The problem is the government won't let it happen because we can't really have a restructuring and a legitimate recovery until we allow the phony economy that the Fed and Congress have created to unravel. But they won't let it happen. So I think we're going to get a lot more money printing and a lot more regulating and a lot more spending, which is going to prolong this depression.
Well, sure. I mean, up until this point, you predicted the 08 situation. You predicted that it wouldn't help, and within 3 years, it would start imploding even faster. So what I'm saying is, up to this point, you've called the ball game up to halftime. So tell us, what's coming next? I mean, they're announcing new wars they want to have to get, try to get us out of this. They're announcing
wars are the last thing we need, you know, for a number of reasons. Forget about the humanitarian aspect of it. You know, the financial aspect is we don't have the resources to fight a war. We can barely afford peace, although we don't actually have that either right now. But the real crisis is going to come when the world is fleeing the dollar, not embracing it. Right now, as bad as it is, the dollar is actually going up. Treasuries are going up. People are buying dollars in treasuries as they sell stocks. When the real crisis happens, they're going to be selling dollars in treasuries. That's the real crisis. Then the dollar plunges, then interest rates go up, and then prices go through the roof. And that is what's really going to turn this into a crisis, because it's going to be an inflationary depression.
Well, isn't this like a seesaw? Talking to Dr. Paul Craig Roberts, the father of Reaganomics, just about 3 months ago, he said, Alex, you could see a big sell-off of gold. It'll go up later even more as people run from the euro to the dollar. Then they'll run from the dollar to the euro. But overall, both the currencies in the long term, or even medium term, are going down. And I know you've talked about that, that there could be this run into treasuries for a time, but that's the sign that the circling of the toilet bowl is basically coming to its final conclusion.
Yeah, well, look, the Fed came out yesterday and didn't promise endless money printing. They just did this Operation Twist, which is actually going to backfire. The markets are going down, but I believe the Fed will eventually cave in. They will. You know, it's a game of chicken between the markets and the Fed, and the Fed is going to blink. The Fed is going to give the market what it craves. It's going to feed the addiction for cheap money, quantitative easing. It's coming, and when that happens, gold goes up and the dollar goes back down. But right now, maybe the market doesn't realize that that's coming, and you're getting a lot of liquidation. As people who believed that there was a recovery, there were a lot of people who managed money who actually believed that the U.S. economy was getting better. I knew that was just an illusion, but most people didn't. Well, now that reality is rearing its ugly head, that's causing a lot of the people who invest money to have to, you know, change their portfolios around to take into account this new information. And so you're getting a lot of unwinding of trades that were based on a recovery that just is not happening.
So what's going to unfold then? I mean, clearly they're not going to take Ron Paul's advice. They're not going to take your advice. They're not going to take Dr. Paul Kirk Roberts' advice. They're not going to take Bob Chapman's advice or Gerald Celente's advice or John Williams' advice. They're not going to take Rubini's advice. They're not going to take Rogers.
Remember, Rubini's advice is the exact opposite of mine. Remember, Rubini wants more stimulus. He wants more government.
No, you're right. And he's also said we weren't really in a recession for a while, but now he's kind of jumping over to my view. But my point is, they're going ahead with their current program of more stimulus, more QE3. What is that going to do?
It's just going to do more harm. It's going to just do more. This creates more inflation. You know, the key isn't to stimulate consumption or stimulate housing. The government's got it backwards. I mean, we stimulate. The reason we're in trouble is because we overstimulated those things in the first place. We need to reverse all that. We need the government to get out of the way so we can save and we can invest and we can produce and we can work our way back out of debt and repair the damage that bad monetary and fiscal policy has done to the economy. We're not going to repair the damage by breaking it more, but that's all they're doing. But I know they're going to continue with this because that's all they know. They are convinced that we need more spending, even though we're spending like crazy. They're convinced we need to go deeper into debt. Look, Bernanke thinks that the problem with the economy is that rates aren't low enough. I mean, they've never been this low. How can we get them much lower? The fact of the matter is, low rates are part of the problem. They're not part of the
solution. Peter, what about the two-tier system?
Sure.
What about the two-tier system, though? The big banks, the institutions, they get it at zero or less than zero, basically free money. For the general public, though, they're paying high interest rates. I mean, isn't that why the big mega private banks, Goldman Sachs, JP Morgan, and others, are very happy with what's happening? I mean, this is a command-control economy.
They've been happy. They've gotten bailed out. And my feeling is, if the Fed withholds the next round of QE, if we don't have QE3, we're going to have TARP 2. Because I think these major banks are about to fail again if the government doesn't rescue them. And the rescue is going to either have to take the form of QE or TARP. And, you know, maybe the public, as much as they don't like the QE, they probably dislike TARP even more. So I think that the government is going to go the route of the money printing rather than the bailouts. Although in order to bail them out, they need the Fed to print money. So if we get TARP, we end up getting both. But, you know, I don't want Americans to have access to cheap credit to consume. And in a free market, they wouldn't. It's all the government subsidies that enable people to borrow money for consumption. I want people to save money and then buy things that they can afford. We need credit to go to businesses to make capital investments that can grow the economy and create jobs and that provide the means for paying off the debt. If you borrow money to invest, the investment returns will pay off your debt. If you borrow money to consume, you have no way of paying off the debt.
Peter Schiff joins us, the CEO of Euro Pacific Capital. Peter, there is a method to this madness in my view, but I want you to give us your take on it. Just like we saw in October and in the month before that, in September in 2008, when they wouldn't give them the TARP money, Paulson went into Congress and said there'll be blood in the streets, martial law, total collapse, and held people hostage. And when Congress wouldn't pass it, because they were getting 1,000-to-1 phone calls against it, as Barbara Boxer admitted, they went public and fear-mongered. Well, we've seen the heads of the IMF, the World Bank, the head of the European Central Bank, all come out yesterday and say, total collapse if you don't do QE3. And then Bernanke says, okay, I'll do QE3 with this twist scam.
Well, the twist ain't QE3, because remember, he's buying $400 billion of long-term, but he's selling $400 billion of short-term. So he's not actually expanding the balance sheet. He's just twisting a little bit, but he's actually going to put the squeeze on the banks, which is going to backfire on Bernanke. Because, see, remember what happens if we reduce interest rates so that people can refinance their mortgages and reduce their payments, that represents a loss to the banking sector because the banks own the mortgages and the banks are already in trouble. And if you take away their cash flow, they're going to be in bigger trouble. And so, you know, this is not going to work.
Do you think Bernanke's really doing this to try to make the big banks loan?
I think he's doing it out of desperation. He wants to do something, and so this is what he's doing because he doesn't want to be seen as doing nothing. He's doing something. He's grasping for straws.
Okay, so if the big banks do start loaning all these trillions, Peter, won't that accelerate inflation?
If what?
If the big banks do start loaning all this money they've gorged on,
they are loaning the money. They're loaning it to the government. They're buying treasuries. You know, they're buying. You know, they're loaning it for home mortgages and student loans and all kinds of stuff. The money's just not sitting there. Unfortunately, you know, if the government wasn't borrowing all this money, there'd be more money available for business.
Sure. Look. Put it in layman's terms. The point I'm trying to get at here is we saw fear mongering to get new monetary policy that the system wanted 3.5 years ago. Now we're seeing the same fear-mongering. Clearly, all the heads of the big central banks coming out and talking about gloom and doom and total collapse and greatest crisis, they know that's going to kill the stock market. So normally, even if things are bad, they'll lie and say they're great. Why did they come out in the last 48 hours and scream bloody murder, thus precipitating the stock market plunge?
Well, I don't think that was their intention. You know, I don't think that they said, hey, let's make the stock markets go down. They were probably surprised. I bet Ben Bernanke is very surprised at the way the market reacted to his announcement yesterday. I think he probably thought the markets were going to like it. You know, and so he's probably scratching his head right now trying to figure out how to undo the damage.
But but normally you get a Federal Reserve head or an IMF or World Bank head or European Central Bank head comes out and talks about total collapse. And I mean, I've got all these headlines here. They've been doing this the last 2 days. I'm no rocket scientist, Peter. That's going to make people not have confidence.
Well, I don't know if they're talking total collapse. Who's saying that?
Oh, there's a bunch of them here saying greatest crisis, world in danger zone, Zolik. They're talking about, you know, worse than 08. I mean,
it's going to be worse than 08. I mean, but in many cases, they're probably sugarcoating it. I don't know if they even know how bad it is. But the real problem is that the monetary system of the world does not work because the dollar is the center of it. The dollar is the focal point of all these problems. See, the world is trying to continue to grow by selling products to America. But we're broke. We can't afford these products. And even though they keep lending us money, we still can't afford them because that's how broke we are. So the only way the global economy can heal is if it gets out of this dollar system where the dollar is allowed to sink and other currencies are allowed to rise so that instead of the Chinese, for example, trying to produce goods for us, they produce goods for themselves. But meanwhile, you know, you've got all these currency wars brewing now because of this dollar peg. Like you saw what happened in Brazil. You know, they were upset because their currency was rising against the RMB, so they imposed tariffs and then their currency tank, but you've got all this global trade and currency wars because the current monetary system without gold, using the dollar instead of gold, does not work.
Okay, Peter, what about the Swiss then? What did their move a few weeks ago to lower the value of their currency do?
Yeah, more proof that it doesn't work. I mean, you have a race to the bottom now. The Swiss had a strong currency because they were doing it right. They had a vibrant economy. They didn't have government budget deficits. They had a trade surplus.
Sure.
They had a current account surplus. And then what they did is they decided to destroy their currency because it was going up against the euro. It's like, you know, Europe was jumping off a bridge. And so Switzerland said, hey, let's jump off the same bridge. But this shows you it doesn't work. The reserve, you can't have a monetary system that forces people to be reckless and irresponsible.
Well, that's the globalist model, is lower everybody instead of building things up and get everybody dependent. So in simple information that lay folks can understand, what's going on in this crazy bond market? How, if we know the U.S. is in deep trouble, could the bonds be going up even though their yield is lower? And how does this unwind?
Well, it's going to unwind badly because, you know, nobody who's buying, if you look at the yield on a 10-year bond at 1.7%, nobody who's buying that bond plans to hold it to maturity. No one wants to clip those coupons for 10 years. At some point, the people buying the bonds are going to want out. And the question is, who's going to be there to take the other side of the trade? The only one is going to be the Fed. And it's going to have to create massive inflation to buy up all these bonds when the bubble bursts. This is the problem. This is the mother of all bubbles. And when it bursts, interest rates go sky high. And then whatever problems we have now with our debts are going to be compounded because it's going to be so much more expensive to service them.
Okay, what would you do if you were the president, the Treasury Secretary, and the Congress all rolled in one? If you could wave a magic wand, what would you do to try to reverse the situation we're in?
If I had a magic wand, I'd probably have to go back in time because we'd have to reverse the policies from 20 or 30 years ago. That would be the thing we would do. But assuming I didn't have a magic wand, but I had powers, I had the power to, you know, I was a king or something, and I can dictate what was going to be done. You know, we would have to allow the economy to restructure. And what that means sound money. That means higher interest rates, substantially higher. That means we let all the banks that have to fail, fail. We don't bail anybody out. We shrink government dramatically. We eliminate entire departments and agencies. We dramatically cut government spending. We try to reform our tax code so it doesn't punish, work and entrepreneurs. We got to abolish all these rules and regulations that are unnecessarily not only diminishing our rights, but running up the cost of doing business. We have to really unravel the entire social welfare monstrosity that has been built up over the years. That is the only solution that's going to work. And the problem is you're going to need a king to do that because no politician is going to vote to do that, because they're afraid that when they take away the benefits, they're not going to get reelected.
And instead, they're just going to keep running us down the same path and passing the buck. I want to do 5 more minutes with you, if you can, to end the show here. Peter Schiff joins us. And, of course, if you're watching on television via the web, you can also see his website there behind him. But we'll give you that when we come back. I want to specifically talk about then what's going to happen if we continue down this path versus some of the other options. And some people would spin it that Schiff is calling for austerity. That's not what he's calling for. It's calling for common sense solutions. Instead, we're going to get the king type deal through the bureaucracy, and they're going to cut a lot of things, but only to prop up the big derivatives bubble.
Are you tired of spending money for metal canning lids year after year? Then stop. Stop buying metal lids and get Tatler reusable canning lids. Made of USDA and FDA approved food grade plastic, Tatler canning lids let you safely store emergency preparedness foods for years. Traditional metal lids are single use throwaways that contain BPA, but Tatler canning lids are indefinitely reusable and guaranteed to last a lifetime when used as designed for home canning and contain no BPA. Tatler lids are dishwasher safe, perfect for standard pressure or water bath canning, eliminate food spoilage from acid corrosion, fit standard mason jars, and are proudly made in the USA. Place orders by phone at 877-747-2793 or go to reusablecanninglids.com. That's 1-877-747-2793 or go to reusablecanninglids.com. That's reusablecanninglids.com. Tatler Reusable Canning Lids, the original since 1976.
Alex Jones here with vital information concerning our nation's fragile food supply. Folks, there are some truly dangerous trends forming, and I think it's important for my listeners to do 3 things right away. Number 1, study the past. History really does repeat itself. Number 2, learn to spot the dangerous food shortage trends. Number 3, take decisive action. A perfect storm is brewing, or a global food crisis. That's why I'm telling everyone to read the new book, Rising Prices, Empty Shelves. Warning signs that trigger the deadliest famines in history. Don't get caught unprepared when the crisis hits. This book is only available at risingprices.emptyshelves.com. You'll also get a free copy of Supermarket Survival, How to Cut Your Grocery Bills in Half. Again, that website is risingprices.emptyshelves.com. That's risingprices.emptyshelves.com.
What nutrition are you missing that's leading to the four major diseases? Cancer, arthritis, heart disease, and Parkinson's. There are at least 80,000 medical studies that show a lack of the protein glutathione to be linked to cancer, heart disease, Parkinson's, macular degeneration, lung disease, digestive diseases, diabetes, Alzheimer's, ALS, rheumatoid arthritis, and lupus. In all, at least 68 diseases. What is the number one food by which your body is most empowered to increase its glutathione production? It is undamaged whey protein from grass-fed cows. One World Whey is truly the first undamaged whey protein. All other whey protein powders are damaged by heat, chemicals, and filtration. One World Whey is the most life-giving whey protein powder ever produced. Call 888-988-3325. That's 888-988-3325. Or visit oneworldwhey.com. That's oneworldwhey.com.
Okay, we're going to be back tonight, 7 o'clock Central, InfoWars Nightly News. It's going to be completely jam-packed. Peter Schiff is our guest, and we put him back up there on screen. I can give folks his website. It's Peter Schiff Radio, schiffradio.com. Our websites are infowars.com and prisonplanet.tv. Again, his site is schiffradio.com. Peter, look, a lot of people are going to say you're calling for, quote, austerity. My issue is the establishment is offering a different alternative to what you've been promoting, as you know, and that's keep government big and just start cutting the military pensions and the general public's pensions, but keep the corporate welfare, the defense going, keep the bailout of the big banks going. You're calling for something different. You're talking about it across the board. So continue with the type of economic policy you think will get this country going.
The government is basically talking about widespread poverty if we continue on this program. I want austerity for government. I want government to shrink because that's our wealth that they're spending and dissipating. If the politicians really care about the little guy, stop spending their money. Stop regulating and taxing their jobs away. Stop destroying the value of their savings and their wages with inflation. You see, that's the only solution that works. I want the government to cut back. I don't want the people to have to be austere, but I want them to save more. I want them to earn money and not spend it. But, you know, that's not austerity. I mean, austerity would be, you know, massive cuts in government. I want austerity for the people who are in the wagon, not the people who have been pulling the wagon. You know, we need to lighten their burden, and the people who are riding in the wagon have to get out and push. That's what they need to do. So the government has to stop encouraging the able-bodied to go on a free ride and then ask for sacrifice by saying that the people who are pulling the cart need to pull harder so that the people in the wagon can get a smoother ride.
Well, there's no doubt that government dependency has created monstrous groups across this nation and the world, entitled, dumbed down, crime-loving people on average, and it's killing us. The problem is government is going to use those people as their army to rob what's left of the middle class, Peter. Yeah,
and the biggest irony is the very people who think they're benefiting from the government largress, those are the ones whose standard of living is being diminished the most. If we just got the government out of the way, they would enjoy a much better quality of life in a vibrant, free economy. But, you know, the government has got them so used to these free checks, and they're living still in poverty, they have no idea how much better their lives would be if they had freedom instead of government dole.
That's right. In the last 2 minutes we've got left, we know they're not listening to your advice. They're demonizing Ron Paul. They're probably not going to change course until things get even worse. So what's going to happen in the short term?
Hey, in the short term, there's no way to know. I mean, as I said, I think the markets are going to be under pressure until the Fed caves. And caving means giving in on the QE, coming out with a bigger plan of more asset purchases, whether it's bonds, mortgages, who knows. But I think the Fed is going to commit to additional money printing. And then, you know, then the markets will rally, and gold will rally more, and oil will rally more. That's what's going to happen. But in the interim, can we see the dollar and the gold market or the bond market reverse this pattern? I mean, are people going to wake up? Right now, people are buying the dollar and treasuries as if those are the safe havens. They're not the safe havens at all. I think that's where the most risk lies. So I think we need to see a change of perception among the world as to exactly what is safe and what is risky. And I think when that happens, then we see a much bigger crisis here in the U.S. because we are benefiting from the perception that there's safety in the dollar and in treasuries. But as long as that happens, it only exacerbates the imbalances. It lets our government go deeper into debt. It screws up our economy even more. Yeah, we benefit in the short run because we can consume a little bit more and go a little bit deeper into debt. But all that's going to come back to bite us in the end.
Sure, as it has been. Peter Schiff, thanks for spending time with us.
Sure.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, that's it for this Thursday edition. Back live tomorrow, 11 a.m. Central, and live this Sunday, 4 to 6 p.m. But before I'm back here tomorrow, I'll see you tonight, 7 o'clock, PrisonPlanet.tv, InfoWars and Nightly News.
Thank you for listening to GCN. Visit GCNLive.com today.